War.com reports officials have confirmed the Iran nuclear talks were extended until Monday, the latest in a series of short extensions that followed up the initial June 30th deadline. There was a breakthrough in the talks last Saturday, but since then the official line is that things are going poorly, with claims of the U.S. changing its demands at the last minute and reports of shouting matches in the middle of the talks by top officials on all sides. At the same time, Israeli media are reporting a done deal in the talks, saying that there are plans to sign the pact early next week and that the deal was reached after the U.S. made some capitulations over the past 2 to 3 weeks. Israeli reports are typically negative about the prospect of a deal, of course, but the report of a deal does make sense as the Associated Press is reporting President Obama has been clearing out his schedule for the next few days, awaiting news from Vienna. On the other hand, reports from last weekend also suggested a deal was imminent, only to be followed up with reports of changed demands from the U.S. and other Western nations involved in the talks. Throughout all of this, the only official U.S. statement has been threats to walk away from the talks at any moment.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports nearly 80 years after it was founded, U.S. Airways has made reservations for its final flights. The carrier will complete its last two flights in October before the name becomes entirely absorbed into its merger with American Airlines. Flights 496 and 434 will be the final two U.S. Airways flights to take off on the evening of October 16th, according to the airline. Both flights are scheduled to depart Phoenix and San Francisco, respectively, at the exact same minute, but officials said the San Francisco flight will be the last to land in Philadelphia 4 hours later. The Phoenix flight will land in Denver just after midnight local time. American Airlines decided to merge the carrier's reservations into one system on October 17th, which will officially retire the U.S. Airways name. American Airlines executive Maya Liebman said, "At that point, we're going to be one airline for our customers. We will have one website, one mobile app, one set of travel policies, and elite benefits." Another executive said the great news for customers is that after our cutover on October 17th, the travel experience will be seamless.
FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. I trust Coinbase. You should too. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports Washington State took in $65 million in tax revenue from the recreational cannabis market during the first 12 months since it became legal to produce and sell. According to the data released by the Washington State Liquor Control Board, which oversees the distribution of cannabis, the revenue was generated by cannabis sales of more than $260 million from June 2014 to June 2015. Voters in Washington State, as well as in Colorado, approved measures legalizing personal possession and consumption of cannabis in 2012, ushering in the licensing and taxation of retail stores that offer a range of cannabis products. Despite remaining against federal law, possession of small amounts of cannabis is also legal in the District of Columbia, Oregon, and Alaska. In Washington State, customers who are 21 and older are legally allowed to purchase up to 1 ounce of cannabis. They are also allowed to buy up to 16 ounces of cannabis-infused product in solid form or up to 72 ounces of cannabis-infused product in liquid form. Retailers sold more than 23,000 pounds of cannabis of the 31,000 pounds produced in Washington during the year. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
An alarming new study finds that people suffering from stress-related disorders react poorly to being trapped in underwater elevators. A tired 398-month-old throws a tantrum, and a little clay thing is purchased at an arts festival. And now, an eerily perfect recap of this week's news. The Catholic Church reversed its long-held stance against gay marriage this week, after meeting Connecticut couple Tony and Craig. The vacationing pair dazzled the Pope and assorted clergy with their witty conversation and true loving affection for each other, leading Vatican officials to conclude that love is love and it's silly to put restrictions on it in this day and age. The Chinese people announced that they would be willing to forgive most of the United States' $1.16 trillion debt if Americans agreed to dress up in costumes and perform silly dances for them. Chinese officials encouraged U.S. citizens to wear sequined vests and prance around while slapping their big fat American tummies, promising that the more humiliating the performance, the more debt will be erased. In sports, NASCAR fans are deeply puzzled by a mysterious black family seen attending multiple races.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. Welcome to the program, the live Sunday edition. That's where we are right now. You can join us here toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you in the studio tonight, you have me, Ian.
And Chris, not Cantwell.
Hey, Chris, good to have you on for a second show. It's actually the first show we've done together.
That's correct.
And you were on previously, I think, when Mark and I were out of town.
Yep.
Is that right?
Daryl and Danica.
Sounded like you had a good time. So
yeah, I had fun.
Figured I'd have you back in here. You just got back from, I don't know how much we can say, but picking someone you care about up at the airport. And you've got an interesting story to tell about illegal air travel here in a little bit. Is that right?
Yeah, it was kind of interesting. And we can talk in general, but our family's in Pennsylvania, and my girlfriend had to go down there for a bit of a family emergency. Her father's been ill. And it was kind of spur of the moment. So we were looking at airfare out of Boston or Manchester, or looking at Amtrak, or does she drive, or what do we do? And some family of ours in Pennsylvania said, well, why don't we just call Captain Jack? I'm like, Captain Jack? Well, that sounds
not
intriguing.
His real name.
Not his real name. So basically, this guy is a pilot. He loves to fly. He has invested a lot of money into his aircraft. He owns it with somebody else. Mm-hmm. And, you know, basically, if you help pay for gas, he'll come pick you up and fly you where you want to go. And some friends of ours have used him to go on family vacations and stuff like that. Hmm. The kicker in this whole thing is according to the FAA, this is all illegal.
Wow.
Yeah. Unless you are a commercial pilot or a authorized air carrier, you cannot do this stuff. They have some regulations out there that say that under very narrow circumstances that you can share the cost of gasoline and, you know, jet fuel or whatever it happens to be, and oil and maintenance. But if you make a habit out of this, then somebody's probably going to be looking at you more carefully.
Because he would essentially be competing with the major air carriers, and they don't want that to happen, right? I mean, that's where this comes from. It's protectionism.
Of course. I think the air carriers spend enough money in lobbying that they feel that they should not have any competition from private sector. So this, to me, is really kind of an Uber or a Lyft sort of thing.
Right.
People looking at a very convenient way to travel short distances, and say up to 500 miles. We looked at this, you know, there was a premium that we paid to do this. But if I figure in the cost of gasoline and the cost of my time to go somewhere like Boston or Manchester.
Right, here from Keene, New Hampshire, it's 2 hours to Boston. It's an hour and a half to Manchester. I mean, you're looking at a 3 or 4 hour drive time just to get to and from the airport. And if you're billing it 50 or 60 or 100 bucks an hour or whatever for professional services, then there's a lot of hours that you're losing.
Yeah, and you're going to have parking once you get there, and because, you know, you just can't pull up to the curb and leave your car like you used to.
Now, I've heard that these private jet flights are $4,000. You told me yours was more in the range of $400 or something.
Absolutely. And there are some things in that space, but they are run as a real carrier. They have subcontracted out under their, you know, official license to do these sorts of things. But there's a couple websites that have popped up in the last couple of years that have been shot down. One of them is called Air Pooler. And Air Pooler was set up to say, okay, if a pilot's going from Sacramento to Reno anyway, why can't
he
advertise?
Someone.
Yeah, I've got a couple extra people. You help me pay for the gas along the lines of what the FAA says I can do, and everything's good. But when they went to the FAA and said, here's our website, here's our business plan, we've got a guy who's a former deputy chief of the FAA's regulation division, and he says it's okay. What do you guys think? They're like, oh, no, we can't do this. And I'm telling you, I can't stress how convenient it was to fly from Keene to central Pennsylvania.
To right where you needed to go in Pennsylvania, right? Like point one to point two, you didn't have to
5 minutes away on either side. Yeah. It was just
That's
insane.
Incredible.
Yeah, and you know, they encountered some weather on the way down, and he did like every private plane does, adjusted his altitude and went around it, and no problem. And here's one of the crazy things I thought. You know, we go up to the Keene Airport, and we go to General Aviation, and it's a building, and you the front doors were open because it was a nice day. We walk in. I realize that the back doors are also open because it's a nice day, and there's the airplane.
Come through, yeah.
So literally, we walked through the building, not through any metal detectors, not by any...
No TSA.
No TSA, nothing like that. I got up there, and I said, you know, I did put my handgun in the car before I came out here, and he said, why? you're allowed to do that.
It's not federal property. It's the Keene Airport is run by the city, right? It's not.
I suppose now he might not have been completely knowledgeable about that aspect of it, but bringing a you know privately owned handgun onto a privately owned plane,
legal.
There's nothing wrong with that.
Okay,
it's kind of like getting in your car, and evidently that was no big deal. So, yeah, I was just really jazzed by the whole thing, and while it was not. It wasn't cost prohibitive, but it wasn't the cheapest solution.
Well, I mean, if you think about it, he wasn't coming to Keene before this.
Right, right.
So he made a special trip up here, yep. And the fact that it was a few hundred bucks for a one-way ticket on a private jet seems...
Not jet. This was a prop plane.
Private plane.
Yeah.
Okay. You had told me it is had six seats, so that sounds a little larger than a
it was
a jumper.
Big private plane.
Interesting.
So single engine still.
Okay.
But guys, you know, they like to do this with their little Cessna 182s, which is... tiny, but if it would have been two of us going down there, suddenly it would have been less expensive
because same amount of gas,
exactly.
Same amount of maintenance.
Yeah,
that makes sense.
Yeah, and it was just nice not to have anybody go through my carry-on or
you know, it's interesting, Chris, that this shows maybe the listeners who hadn't picked up on this that obviously some terrorist could do this, right? Like if some terrorist wanted to get on a private plane and carry a bomb somewhere, they could totally do that. So the fact that you can do this, now you're saying that what he did wasn't strictly legal, but at the same time, there really was no way to catch him at it, right? Like he's just coming into a private airport, he's leaving a private airport, and somebody's going with him, right?
Yeah.
The only way you would know or that the authorities would know about this is if they were conducting some sort of a sting operation on these kind of air pooling operations, and that seems fairly unlikely that that would be going on because it's like those underground kitchens where they have the
right.
The meals that people will go and attend. There's some fancy chef who cooks in his own kitchen and cooks for people. It's word of mouth that gets people in there. So generally, you know, hopefully you would not be spreading word of mouth amongst federal agents.
We hope
for
not.
Instance. So it would seem to be that you could operate in this way relatively safely. And so, therefore, you know, how hard would it be for some terrorist group to have their own private plane flying them around? It just goes to show that the whole security apparatus is nothing more than show. It's nothing more than what they've called security theater. I mean, we've seen this in another way where the red team, as they call it, within the TSA tests themselves. And the most recent test results was like they missed 90 to 100% of the bomb parts and the guns and things like that that they were smuggling in. So you've got that kind of an example of how this is security theater. It's just for show. It's just to make people think that they're safe when they're on these airplanes. But really, if the idea is to stop bad terrorist-type folks from flying, they haven't done that.
No, and they never will because these planes, you know, when you talk about a small, say, 2 to 6 seat aircraft, propeller-driven, that can take off just as easily in a field, which is, of course, what drug runners used to do in Florida.
Sure,
and
get
the
an
South.
Airstrip.
Right.
Private airstrip. And then the only way that somebody would know they were there is if they saw them on radar before they landed or something like
Absolutely.
That.
Absolutely. But with General Aviation, you know, they do file a flight plan and they let everybody know. They certainly follow most of the rules. But nobody really asks, you know, how many people are flying with you on the way back or anything like that.
There's no one there to ask him that, apparently.
Exactly.
Right?
Yeah. There were a bunch of pilots sitting around the pilot's lounge BSing about how the weather is. That was it, which was really great. I just I
That's
looked
a cool
at it
story.
And I just thought this is one of those areas that just needs to happen.
But it's illegal.
It
so
is.
So this air pooled site or air pooling, was it called?
Airpooler.com. The site's still up, but I don't think.
And what is it, like a message that says, we're sorry, we can't provide this service?
Actually, it still looks like it's ready to go.
Interesting. Yeah. I'll have to take a look at that. That's fascinating stuff. There's more coming up here. Maybe you've got some experience in private flight and you want to add in your thoughts to the mix here. Obviously, this is yet another example of the security theater that exists here in the United States. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, plus the latest from Greece on the way. By the way, that Bitcoin price is over $300 per Bitcoin right now. It's very exciting. It's Free Talk Live. More coming up.
For P150, P150GA, P150LK, P150TN, C250A, C250E, C250Q. Not available in all states.
Have you put off seeing the dentist because you can't afford to go? Are big dental bills taking a big toll on your wallet? Would you like to have dental insurance, but think it's too expensive? If you answered yes to any of these questions, call Physicians Mutual Insurance Company for a free information kit. See how you can help protect your teeth and your wallet by calling now. 1-800-496-5920. This is real dental insurance that can help cover over 300 procedures. Everything from cleanings and fillings to crowns and dentures. Your acceptance is guaranteed for one of these insurance policies, even if you're retired. You can see any dentist you choose, and you'll never pay a deductible. Call in the next 10 minutes, and we'll rush you a free information kit with all the details. 1-800-496-5920. That's 1-800-496-5920. 1-800-496-5920.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. Call 1-888-379-MYTV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. So, disable the cable and get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-888-379-MYTV. Right now, to sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99 and up to four rooms. And there's no equipment to buy. That includes your free HDTV upgrade, your free DVR upgrade, and your free professional installation. And the best part? The pristine digital picture and sound. Call 1-888-379-MYTV. So, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-888-379-MYTV. 1-888-379-MYTV. Disable the cable, cut costs, and get more. Call 1-888-379-MYTV. 1-888-379-MYTV.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting bloc and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Mm-hmm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live, and we're talking about something that apparently the FAA considers to be illegal. But Chris, who's here with us in the studio tonight, says that it's awesome. So, of course, they're going to make it illegal.
Of course.
It's awesome. Talking about the idea of flying planes, flying in a plane with a pilot who's going somewhere already, like essentially the equivalent of an aircraft Uber or Lyft, one of these ride-sharing services for flying. And there's some news about apparently a lawsuit in this area. There's Air Pooler, which you'd mentioned, Chris, previously, and then there's another company called Flyte Now, F-L-Y-T-E Now. And apparently Flyte Now is actually suing the FAA in this case. We'll tell you more about that coming up here in moments, plus the latest from Greece. And, of course, you can join us here toll-free and bring up whatever you'd like. Our number is 855-450-FREE. We also have Skype. The Skype username here is lrn.fm. So feel free to reach out that way. Maybe you think these ride-sharing services for airlines or for small planes and private jets and things like that, that you think these things should be illegal, that it's a danger to the country to have Chris's girlfriend fly down to Pennsylvania. The toll-free number, if you want to join us here, is 855-450-FREE. And I did mention before we went to break there the price of Bitcoin. Wow, it has been an amazing month the last few weeks here for Bitcoin. The price has gone from as low as like 215, I think, within the last month. Now it broke through 310 today.
Yep.
And it broke through 300 last night, I think it was. So it's, I mean, you never know when it's going to stop. It's probably going to go down at some point, but you never know what's going to happen with Bitcoin because, well, tomorrow is a new day and there's all kinds of new things that develop in the Bitcoin universe. We just talked a few nights ago about Backpage.com, which is sort of like a Craigslist that has more adult friendly listings. They're now taking only cryptocurrency for their adult section because Visa and MasterCard told them, yeah, we're not going to provide you with service anymore.
Nice.
So they said, well, we're going to keep operating, and went ahead and hooked up with cryptocurrency, including Bitcoin, which is awesome. So there's just new news that's exciting about Bitcoin every single day. So maybe you're ready to get some, or maybe you're ready to get some more. Go to expresscoin.com. It's the best choice for getting your cryptocurrency. That's Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin. They're all available over at expresscoin.com, whether you're in the U.S. or Canada. They can help you out, and you can get your cryptocurrency of choice with money order or check. And they are fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. Plus, they're a licensed money services business. You can do it from your smartphone. They've got an app, or just do it straight through their website at expresscoin.com. And don't forget to use coupon code FTL. You'll save up to $40 worth, or save on up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency, meaning that you will pay no fee, no transfer fee at all when you change up to 40 bucks into Bitcoin or Litecoin or Dogecoin. So go to expresscoin.com and don't forget coupon code FTL. When you go above 40 bucks, it's, I think, a 3% fee, which is very, very affordable. And so again, that's expresscoin.com with coupon code FTL. Since we were talking about the Air Pooler and Flyte Now, I was just kind of poking around, Chris. This was the first I've heard about this, and I think it's a great idea. Apparently, Flyte Now still has a website. Air Pooler still has a website. And I imagine they would both like to continue operating, but unfortunately, the FAA has gotten in the way for the moment. The story here from dcinno.streetwise.co: appeals court will decide if the FAA can ban Sky Ubers. Story says flight sharing platform developer Flyte Now is suing the FAA. This story, by the way, from January. This is the newest story I could find. If there's a newer development, please let me know on this. But it seems like right now they're waiting for the court to schedule a hearing. But flight sharing platform developer Flyte Now is suing the FAA over the agency's decision in August of 2014 to basically ban its business model. Flyte Now and its competitors like Air Pooler provide a platform similar to Uber or Airbnb to let customers find private pilots with spare seats on their planes, paying part of the flight costs to get a ride. The FAA ruled that this counts as advertising and getting compensation, making it a commercial, not a private flight. Pilots need a different and much more difficult to get operating license for commercial flights, and Flyte Now contends that what it does is legal under rules that let passengers share expenses with private pilots, and has gone to the U.S. Court of Appeals for the District of Columbia to make its case. there's more to the story. But it seems like one of the obvious arguments here is this is good for the environment, right? Like,
yeah.
People have pointed out that private air travel is a fairly expensive thing, and gas is certainly not cheap.
Right.
It's not really very efficient to take one person from point A to point B when you could take five people from point A to point B. And so this just makes sense from an economics perspective. It makes sense from an environmental perspective. It makes sense from every possible perspective, with the exception of, well, we need to protect the big airlines.
Exactly.
That's all this is about. It's about protecting Delta and whatever the other ones are. And they all gobbled each other up. So I don't even know who's left. I know Southwest is still out there. I think Delta still exists. Didn't Delta gobble up United a few years ago or something like
They're always gobbling up somebody else.
Right. And so that's what you see in this business with this highly regulated airline industry, the big ones, the big airlines, is they're constantly buying out one another and consolidating the industry to just a few players. So, of course, the fewer providers there are for air flight services, the worse the choices will be. The service won't be as good because they won't be as open to competition as they have been in the past. If there are only three providers and there used to be 30, you don't have as much choice in the marketplace anymore.
And this is going to hit. This hits every single level of transportation. And transportation, I think, is probably one of the hardest hit with regulation. You can look at everything from a taxi cab all the way on up to a cruise ship. Every one of those has their own protectionist system in place that's going to keep all competition out.
The cabbies hate Uber and Lyft.
Of course they do.
It's a level of competition they never thought they were going to experience. Uber and Lyft bring this innovative model into the marketplace, and because they're an internet-based company and they're doing something unique and it's outside of the current paradigm of government regulations, the laws that have actually been written, they're brilliantly outside of that paradigm. The government has been unable to really act quickly enough to try to regulate them. They are doing it in some areas and they're cracking down. Like, for instance, there's a news story recently about Uber leaving Broward County, Florida, because it's just too oppressive there for them to operate. And so that is happening in some places. But in other places, Uber's just operating and everything's fine. Their customers are satisfied. And the cabbies are still out there too, right?
Yeah.
They're still getting business.
Well, once I got down there, I traveled by train down there to meet her. So this literally was the weekend of planes, trains, and automobiles. We used every form of transportation we could.
I know you wanted to talk more about the Amtrak experience.
We'll get to that one, absolutely. But that was once I arrived in Harrisburg, taking train, you don't really end up as close to where you're going as, say, if you had a private plane that flew you there. She had her family pick her up, and it was very close. I had to get from Harrisburg to Carlisle, Pennsylvania, and that was a little bit more challenging.
Did you take a cab or?
Well, my choices were cab or Uber. Mm-hmm. And
Uber will go that kind of distance.
Absolutely, it's about a half hour drive or something like that.
That's good to know. I didn't realize that. I mean, I guess it makes sense, right? Because when I think about Uber or Lyft, I think they only operate in a city, right? Like, it's only Austin and only in New York City and only in Philly or whatever. And so I guess if they're picking you up in the city they're operating, they'll still drive you to where you want to go.
Yep.
Is that right?
Absolutely.
All right. There's more on the way here about the lawsuit, too. I'm interested in learning more about that. FlightNow suing the FAA, basically saying what we're doing should be legal under your own regulations. More on the way. 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or state in back taxes, you know they'll never stop coming after you. With bank levies, wage garnishments, they'll even seize your home or business. The good news? A government program for tax debt forgiveness. It's called the Fresh Start Initiative.
I'm Paul Sibley. With U.S. Tax Shield, we can help navigate the new laws, get you protected, and resolve your tax issues permanently.
Call the experts at U.S. Tax Shield now for your free consultation and get a guaranteed quote to resolve your case. Call 800-436-6451. That's 800-436-6451.
Did you know some countries are now banning GMO foods? It's true. That's why for quality storable foods, you need ready-made resources. For over 19 years, we've become the name you can trust for thousands of products, like Numana Healthy Food Storage. All Numana storable foods are non-GMO, non-soy and gluten-free available. Call 800-627-3809 or click readymaderesources.com. Ready-made resources. We don't just sell the products, we live it.
Do you ever say, I could care less?
when you really mean the opposite, you mean to say, I couldn't care less. It's a common mistake. You are judged by how you speak, especially if you're looking for work, with so many more applicants than openings now. But even if you're not, avoiding common misstatements will help you make the most of the dozens of conversations and transactions that crowd your daily routine. So whatever you say, don't say whatever as a single word sentence. It's the most annoying expression in the American English language, according to a recent poll. And avoid cliches like the plague. Just kidding. But seriously, at the end of the day, you'll want to avoid this scenario, sounding like everyone else. For more tips, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Ovaltine. Give your kids the nutrition they need to be their best. Visit us at OvaltineUSA.com. Telling your child about healthy food choices is important, but showing her what to eat goes a lot further. Have her help create the grocery list, then bring her to the store with you. Picking out healthy foods together helps kids get in the habit of thinking about what they're eating every day. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Free Talk Live.
My father was a police officer most of my life. He went to prison for police brutality. Wow. And my father was the chief.
What was he like at home with you when you were growing up? Was he violent with you?
Never with me. He practically ignored me, actually. I never really had a relationship with him, but extremely violent to my mother. He beat her up practically every day of my life.
Oh, my God.
He never touched me or my sisters or my brothers.
Did he have a drinking problem?
No, he's never drank alcohol in his
life. Wow, so violent without alcohol. Very interesting.
I lived in a very small town in West Virginia, and my sisters and I and my brothers, we could do whatever we wanted. There were no laws for us. I could drive as fast as I want.
You said that he abused your mother, beat her frequently. Did she ever leave him?
Yes, numerous times, but she couldn't do anything because there was no help for her. There were no police to call to help her. There was no help for her because my father was very well connected. He knew everybody in the state.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm. While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
We're back with Free Talk Live, and you can join us here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And, of course, you can also join us on Skype at Skype username LRN.fm. With you in the studio tonight, it's Ian.
And Chris.
We've been talking about traveling and specifically flying to your destination on a flying sharing service. So sort of like a ride share for the skies. Unfortunately, the FAA has decided it's illegal to provide a service like this unless you've gotten some kind of commercial pilot's license. So if you are licensed to operate commercially, then you can charge. And then, of course, you have to jump through all kinds of ridiculous hoops and basically bend over for the state in a lot of ways. If you're just a private pilot with a private plane or jet or something and you like to fly yourself somewhere and then you bring a friend along who gives you money, then the FAA is saying that's a problem.
Yeah.
Even though
it's crazy. And it's even beyond that. Even if you are a commercial pilot, I think they get into a place where you have to be a registered air carrier.
What does that mean?
That basically means now I'm an airline. And if you can imagine all the regulation that must go with setting up a officially sanctioned airline, I can't even imagine.
I can't imagine that would even be within the range of affordability for somebody with just a private plane. You know, if you're going to be a registered air carrier, you likely have to, throw a bunch of money at something, some sort of government application, right? Like I know.
Oh, yeah.
I know that in the radio business, it costs thousands of dollars just to apply to get a license.
Right.
They don't even guarantee they'll give it to you.
Absolutely. And when you look at these pilots, I mean, and I've known a lot of them. I've done a little skydiving, and I'd like to go up in small planes if ever I get the opportunity to. These guys put in huge investments in their equipment. It's not like running out and buying a Kia. These guys, you go to the low end, you know, you're spending $60,000-$70,000 for something, and you have enormous upkeep. You've got all the costs associated with keeping it in an airport and the maintenance and all the federal regulations that require your maintenance schedules and what you have to do to the aircraft, which you want to do. You want it to fly safely.
Yes, you would like to get where you want to go.
But these guys have huge investments, and the plane that this was, like I said, it was a six-seater. That's big for a small prop plane. Those, for a 1978 model ballpark, because I had to Google it and see how much these things cost, you can get into one of those for about $500,000. $500,000. Yeah, so typically, it's a couple guys that have gone in. You know, they'll pool their money to get one of these
to aircraft, share the plane, just because they like to fly, right?
Yeah.
So, in its ruling, the FAA upends over four decades of established legal precedent and common practice among private pilots, sharing expenses with passengers to make flights on small aircraft more accessible and cost-effective, and creates a new regulatory regime which directly contradicts the current expense-sharing rules. So, FlightNow, which is one of the organizations that had formed to allow people to share private flights like this, they are suing the FAA because the FAA has essentially ruled that what they're doing is illegal, even though they're saying that it is legal because the FAA already has rules that allow passengers to share expenses with private pilots. So how is this any different, they're saying. Flight explained in a blog post, quote, "Under the FAA's new regulatory regime, however, a pilot's mere communication with potential passengers will be considered advertising indiscriminate air transportation services." So just to simply say, oh, you need to leave from Keene, that's going to cost $500. That would be illegal, is what they're saying, even though.
Yes. You've crossed a line there. You've made yourself accessible to public who wants your services. We cannot allow that.
It's the same sharing economy battle over definitions that Uber, Lyft, Airbnb, and other startups have dealt with, but taken to another level, both literally and figuratively. Federal regulators have a lot more control when it comes to air safety and regulation than any city does with regulating car or even hotel startups. The technical reasons the FAA has essentially banned flight sharing may not convince the court, which would put the FAA in a tricky position if it wants to stop FlightNow and its fellows. If what those companies offer is private, not commercial, then the FAA would need to develop a whole new policy to stop it, which I'm sure they're more than happy to do.
Oh, yeah.
If they're allowed to just simply create regulations, as many federal government agencies are allowed to do, then, yeah, they could just simply regulate this out of existence with new pages and pages of words.
Well, Ian, that's going to take a lot of money for them to enforce that too. So we're going to be looking at some budgets going up over at the FAA if they have to contend with these private pilots.
Yeah, they'll need to create a new enforcement wing to go and try to entrap these guys into giving rides to people, which is what's happening in some markets with Uber and Lyft. They are sending undercover cops out there, and they are actually confiscating people's cars. I had a headline from several weeks ago that in New York City, they've seized nearly 500 Uber cars for what they call illegal pickups. So, you know, it's a risky area here that these guys are going into, and good for them for at least trying to sue the FAA. And it will be interesting to hear what the FAA's argument is exactly. You know?
Yeah.
Because are they going to go in to the court and say, yes, we need to protect Delta? I mean, no, they're obviously not going to say that, right?
No, it'll be about protecting the public from these unlicensed carriers. And I look at this and
or from terrorism.
Absolutely, because the terrorists will use FlightNow. It drives me nuts, but I'm slightly encouraged by the fact that the success of Airbnb and success of Uber, it's just these sort of organic things that pop up that fill a niche in the marketplace. And I could easily see FlightNow or Airpooler, you know, have a rating system. How was the plane? Was the plane clean? Was the pilot polite? These are the things I would look for. When I fly commercially, it's a crapshoot. I mean that literally sometimes. It's you just never know what you're going to get. And
I tend to have a better experience on Southwest.
Yeah, me too.
You know, their crew seems to be genuinely cheerful. on most of the Southwest flights I've been on. In fact, I don't remember the last. I think the last time I went on a flight that was not Southwest was, I don't even remember what. Maybe it was one of the big carriers. I just don't even remember which one it was. Northwest or something like that, or Northern something or other. Anyway, it was like night and day difference in how they treated passengers. There was like the woman that was the head stewardess was essentially barking orders at people, and I felt like I was on a Nazi airplane or something like that. They were so ridiculous in how they were treating people.
Fun little fact, Southwest, non-union.
Yeah.
And there's your difference. And if we get into more of my travel, I can talk about Amtrak union employees. It was insane.
Oh, yeah. I definitely want to hear about that. A little bit more about the suit against the FAA. The FAA has said it's concerned that pilots just getting started or who aren't very good will be using the service, leading to passengers getting hurt. It's one of the same arguments that vehicle regulators have made about ride-sharing car services, but it may not be enough to get the court to support its indirect ban of FlightNow and AirPooler. Congressman Joe Kennedy and Todd Rotica, who is a Democrat and Republican respectively, wrote to the FAA asking the agency to come up with regulations that will make it possible for flight-sharing startups to operate. In other words, this is far from over. The FAA has a lot on its plate right now, having been recently chastised for being late on coming up with rules for commercial drone use. The FlightNow lawsuit and related flight-sharing legalization efforts won't resolve anytime soon, and FlightNow, backed by the conservative Goldwater Institute in its lawsuit, is willing to pull out all the stops, claiming discrimination and going right to the Constitution for its defense. Quote, finally, the FAA's sweeping ruling violates the Equal Protection Clause of the Fifth Amendment by treating an occasional expense-sharing pilot the same as it treats commercial air carriers like American or Delta Airlines, they wrote at FlightNow's blog, continuing saying, sometimes the grossest discrimination can lie in treating things that are different as though they were exactly alike. In doing so, the ruling eliminates any meaningful distinction between private and commercial flight operations, and we're challenging the ruling on this ground as well.
I'm looking at another part of FlightNow's blog post, but they also say that the FAA is arguing that when we talked about sharing expenses, the expense sharing rule, mm-hmm. we really meant family and acquaintances. So they're saying there's a real distinction between acquaintances, family, and people who don't know you.
Every person I meet is an acquaintance.
They certainly become one very quickly.
855-450-FREE. That is our toll-free number. Maybe you are on the side of the FAA and you think there needs to be a crackdown on these flights. I highly doubt you're out there. But if you are, you can call in toll-free. 855-450-FREE. Or you can bring up anything you want. Coming up, Chris's experience on Amtrak. That's always interesting. Government travel. We'll come back with it here in moments. It's Free Talk Live.
You, me, and BTC is your Bitcoin and Liberty podcast.
Cryptocurrency decrypted.
We're sitting down with Mr. Jason King.
If you want to f*** with the government, feed homeless people, man.
Jeffrey Tucker.
What's possible in the Bitcoin space? It sounds a little like science fiction, but if you wait enough time, it becomes a reality.
Angela Keaton from antiwar.com.
This is what the United States does with all those killer robots. For Bitcoiners, this is a way to get around that.
Subscribe at youmeandbtc.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX, or my website, danpilla.com.
We the People grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Well, George, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring Simon to their rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think you
excuse
are?
Excuse me.
There is no video and audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make...
Wait,
you gotta go. Now.
Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you're scared me.
Property.
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no.
That's the sound of the men working on the chain.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. It's the live Sunday edition of the program, and you can join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've also got Skype. You can Skype in here. The username is lrn.fm. You do have to send a contact request first. It will be approved once I notice it come in, and then after you're approved, you're good to go to call us on Skype from that point forward. In studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
And Chris.
We've been talking about travel. Specifically air travel, to start with the illegal ride-sharing services. Flight Now is one of them, and Air Pooler is another. Flight Now is suing the FAA to attempt to overturn their decision that essentially flying and sharing a ride is an illegal thing, that it would be somebody operating a commercial air travel business, essentially, or a commercial air carrier, and so unless you are jumping through whatever the hoops are that you need to jump through to be considered a commercial air carrier, it would be illegal to share rides. The Flight Now group is saying that's not what the FAA's own rules say. The FAA, they say in their rules, say it's completely legal for a pilot, a private pilot, to share his costs of a flight with people. And so it's will be interesting to see how that pans out. The article I had was from January. Chris, you said there was a blog post on Flight Now's site from back in April.
Yep.
That they were still filing papers with the court, and there had yet to be a full-on hearing about this. So we don't know where it sits today, but presumably there would be some sort of news had there been any kind of decision rendered. So we'll keep our eyes on that if possible. But if you hear something first and you want to inform us, please do. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So you had some travel that you and your girlfriend engaged in recently, Chris.
And lots of travel.
So she flew down to Pennsylvania. You then took a train,
yeah,
Amtrak, down to meet her and then ultimately drive back up in a rental car.
Yeah.
So tell me more about your Amtrak leg of your trip and what, if anything, interesting transpired.
Well, one thing I like about living in New Hampshire, one of the millions, or let's say 101 reasons I like to live in New Hampshire.
Yeah, there's a lot of good things up here.
Is the availability of train travel. I like the convenience of being close to a train station. It gives me that option versus air travel.
About a half hour away, right?
Or driving.
Something like that.
Well, for me, you know, where I live, Bellows Falls is in Vermont, but that's very, very close. That's literally 15 minutes from my house.
Okay.
So I can hop on a train and I can be in New York, I can be in Washington, I could be anywhere in the country.
But you want to talk about lack of choice. I mean, there's no commercial carriers except for Amtrak, right?
True. I have my choice between types, but I don't have a choice when it comes to Amtrak. And Amtrak is one of our largest monopolies in this country. It goes back to 1970 and one of the biggest bailouts. We tend to think that bailouts are this thing that have just started to kind of happen. And for younger generations, they might think that the bank bailouts in 2008 were the first we'd ever seen. But that's not how it's been. Throughout the 20th century, government has stepped in and bailed out all sorts of different businesses.
Oh, yeah.
Train travel's no different. So there was the largest carrier of passengers back in the 1960s and 1970s. Was the Penn Central Railroad. It was the nation's largest railroad. It had 96,000 employees.
Wow.
Payroll of $20 million a week and all this good stuff. And, of course, they ran into dire straits. And because they were backed by a lot of very important creditors like Chase, Morgan Guarantee, First National Bank, Chemical Bank, these big names in banking back then, some are still around. The government decided to step in and, you know, we just can't. You're too big to fail. Too big to fail. So we're going to make sure that, first of all, it played out just like this. All the creditors were taken care of. Bondholders weren't. The way most things are set up, bondholders should be the first ones to get their money back.
Really?
But in this case, the big banks got their money first. And
not a surprise.
They took the whole thing over and they basically said, well, we're going to nationalize all train travel in the United States. And Amtrak was born in 1971.
Sounds like something you'd see in Venezuela.
Absolutely.
I mean, they nationalize certain things all the time down there.
Yeah. And this, you know, if we look back at our history, we see it playing out time and time again. But this is just one of those cases. So while I have a choice of taking a plane or driving or taking a train, if I take a train, it's going to be with Amtrak in the United States.
That's it.
Yep, that's it. So the other thing that...
There's still freight carriers operating on trains, obviously, but as far as passengers...
Absolutely,
It's only Amtrak, right?
It's only Amtrak. That's all you get. And even in...
Could someone... I wonder... Sorry to interrupt, but...
Go ahead.
I wonder if someone could even start another train company. Like, you know, what... Would it be legal for them to do that? Are they, you know, the regulations even allowing somebody else to step in and try that? Not that it would be economically viable or anything like that.
Oh, I know, right? but if you were to go to, say, Union Pacific and say, you guys have all this track and I'd like to put some passenger trains on there when you're not using them for freight, could you make a little bit of money? I'm sure they would say, no. We don't want to pick that fight with the federal government because they protect themselves. I mean, that's why you can't have freight companies that pop up and use the same tracks and things like that. Mm. But yeah, the Amtrak thing's just pretty much the epic disaster that you would expect. So,
well, yeah, I mean, every time I've ever looked at Amtrak, I've never really been blown away by anything that I've ever seen. I've never actually ridden on an Amtrak before.
Really?
But I have looked at the cost because I, you know, needed to go to New York City a couple times here and there. And it's just, they're inconvenient. When they pick up, when the trains actually run, it's really super inconvenient. Like, unlike airlines, you at least get some choices with an airline. It's not great, but at least you can choose different time frames as far as when you arrive and when you get dropped off. But on Amtrak, you're at their mercy, basically. They'll schedule the trains whenever they darn well please, and you'll schedule your life around it if that's the way you want to go.
Yeah, and for me, Amtrak is the lesser of three evils in this case. I didn't want to drive 8 hours by myself. I don't enjoy that. If I were to drive down to Manchester or do something like that or fly, it would be much more expensive, as we talked about with private planes. And right. I didn't want to go to all the expense of doing that. And I enjoy sitting on a train. It's nice.
You can get some work done, I guess, if the Wi-Fi is working.
They have Wi-Fi. It's generally pretty reliable, and it's just kind of relaxing to me. So occasionally I'll do that.
So how many times have you been on the Amtrak?
Probably two or three since I've been up here.
Okay.
A handful of times in the past. I'm not like an avid train guy or anything.
So what is it like? I mean, do you have to go through security? Because I've heard the security can stop the trains, you know, in the middle of, they stop you somewhere and they can get on and start to harass people. What was it like?
Well, if you go to the website, like before I fly, you know, in the past, certainly after 9/11, I checked out all the new security regulations, and we know what airports are like. You walk in and you know, you're going to get the rubber glove if you give them any guff at all, and they're going to x-ray everything you have. Amtrak's website talks about it the same exact way. There are no weapons allowed on plane or on trains. You cannot carry this. You cannot carry that. And then you go to the train station, in this case, Bellows Falls, Vermont, and it looks like it was plucked out of about 1870. It's a beautiful old building, but there's no security there. You get on the train, there's no security there whatsoever. You've got conductors wearing conductor hats like they did, you know, 50, 60 years ago. And you've got a couple people tending the cafe bar, and there's absolutely zero security at all.
But I have heard that it can happen, right? Like where you go through a bigger city and TSA or whoever will get on and like bring a dog in. I mean, that can happen, right?
That's the potential. So,
but
so
it hasn't happened to you?
Never happened to me. And I'm sort of a firearms guy. I like to you know, make sure I have some form of personal protection with me. And
aren't you an oath keeper?
Yes, I am. Yeah. I like to, you know, especially if I'm going to another state like Pennsylvania where, you know, I'm allowed to do that. I like to take a gun, but I can't do that because the station I'm leaving does not do check baggage. And the place I'm going to doesn't do check baggage. So it's only carry on.
Which is against the rules.
Right. Can't do that.
Is it against the rules or illegal? Both, I would guess.
Probably
right?
Both.
Yeah. All right, so relatively uneventful then? There was nothing, you know, really worth writing home about?
Well, let me tell you about my turkey wrap.
Tell me about that, yeah.
So we're on, I leave about noon, about 1 o'clock, I decide to head to the club car. I'm going to get something to eat. Mm-hmm. And the gentleman there who's maintaining the club car, union employee, everybody's union on Amtrak, he's leaning against the wall. He's kind of half reading a newspaper. I walk up and I say, "How you doing? I would like your turkey BLT wrap, please."
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And he looks at me just like you're looking at me. And I glance around sort of nervously because I'm not sure why he didn't respond in some way. And I say,
"Let me guess, he's on break.
I really like a turkey BLT wrap." He looked at me and said, "I heard you the first time."
Like, I want to hear the rest of the story. Really? Hang on. We'll come back with it. 855-450-FREE. What is this guy's excuse for behaving in this way towards a customer? 855-450-3733. Maybe you've got an Amtrak story you want to tell. You're welcome to join us here on the Live Sunday edition. Or, of course, you can bring up anything you want. Still to come, Greece. What's going on over there? Because Bitcoin's going up. Must be good. Bad news in Greece. Bitcoin's going up. Free Talk Live.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
This is Shaquille O'Neal.
And the Shaquettes.
Reminding you that anytime.
Anytime.
Is a good time.
Good time.
For the cooling, drying, fresh scent of Gold Bond Powder Spray. Like after the gym.
Or a crowded elevator ride.
Or golf.
Or working with farm animals.
Or a hard day's work.
Like sports casting.
You said it, ladies. Stay cool with Gold Bond Powder Spray.
Stay cool with Gold Bond.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a Liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the Free State. Or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Darryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, July 12th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.61 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,163 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $309. Antiwar.com reports officials have confirmed the Iran nuclear talks were extended until Monday, the latest in a series of short extensions that followed up the initial June 30th deadline. There was a breakthrough in the talks last Saturday, but since then the official line is that things are going poorly, with claims of the U.S. changing its demands at the last minute and reports of shouting matches in the middle of the talks by top officials on all sides. At the same time, Israeli media are reporting a done deal in the talks, saying that there are plans to sign the pact early next week, and that the deal was reached after the U.S. made some capitulations over the past 2 to 3 weeks. Israeli reports are typically negative about the prospect of a deal, of course, but the report of a deal does make sense, as the Associated Press is reporting President Obama has been clearing out his schedule for the next few days, awaiting news from Vienna. On the other hand, reports from last weekend also suggested a deal was imminent, only to be followed up with reports of changed demands from the U.S. and other Western nations involved in the talks. Throughout all of this, the only official U.S. statement has been threats to walk away from the talks at any moment.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports nearly 80 years after it was founded, U.S. Airways has made reservations for its final flights. The carrier will complete its last two flights in October before the name becomes entirely absorbed into its merger with American Airlines. Flights 496 and 434 will be the final two U.S. Airways flights to take off on the evening of October 16th, according to the airline. Both flights are scheduled to depart Phoenix and San Francisco, respectively, at the exact same minute, but officials said the San Francisco flight will be the last to land in Philadelphia 4 hours later. The Phoenix flight will land in Denver just after midnight local time. American Airlines decided to merge the carrier's reservations into one system on October 17th, which will officially retire the U.S. Airways name. American Airlines executive Maya Liebman said, "At that point, we're going to be one airline for our customers. We will have one website, one mobile app, one set of travel policies, and elite benefits." Another executive said the great news for customers is that after our cutover on October 17th, the travel experience will be seamless.
FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. I trust Coinbase. You should too. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports Washington State took in $65 million in tax revenue from the recreational cannabis market during the first 12 months since it became legal to produce and sell. According to the data released by the Washington State Liquor Control Board, which oversees the distribution of cannabis, the revenue was generated by cannabis sales of more than $260 million from June 2014 to June 2015. Voters in Washington State, as well as in Colorado, approved measures legalizing personal possession and consumption of cannabis in 2012, ushering in the licensing and taxation of retail stores that offer a range of cannabis products. Despite remaining against federal law, possession of small amounts of cannabis is also legal in the District of Columbia, Oregon, and Alaska. In Washington State, customers who are 21 and older are legally allowed to purchase up to 1 ounce of cannabis. They are also allowed to buy up to 16 ounces of cannabis-infused product in solid form or up to 72 ounces of cannabis-infused product in liquid form. Retailers sold more than 23,000 pounds of cannabis of the 31,000 pounds produced in Washington during the year. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Overburdened with material comforts, America's wealthy can expect another disappointing holiday this year. As Brian Scott tells us, the rich will simply be buying too many things to experience the true meaning of Christmas.
All across the country, those at the top of the economic ladder are denied a privilege that the poorest of the poor take for granted. Rather than fall victim to the rampant consumerism that seems to increase each year, the poor find meaningful joy in simple Christmas traditions, like singing carols to keep warm and hugging relatives who have not yet died. At stores like these, the spiritually bereft must scramble for popular holiday toys in a vain attempt to duplicate the Christmastime happiness that the impoverished enjoy.
Poor people are grateful for just a roof over their heads or something to eat. My wife and I are both lawyers, so that's not enough for us. I certainly hope poor people don't take what they don't have for granted.
This is the Onion News Network.
Welcome to Free Talk Live. It's the live Sunday edition of the program. Joining you tonight, it's me, Ian.
And Chris.
And we will continue. Of course, we'll take your calls about whatever happens to be on your mind. We've been talking travel, specifically government-regulated travel. We talked a lot about the airline world in the first hour, specifically the idea of having ride-sharing in the sky. So imagine Uber or Lyft, these new services that will allow you to connect with people who are willing to give you a ride somewhere at usually a better price than what you'd pay a cab to take you somewhere. What about the same thing for airlines? What about getting a private jet or a prop, you know, jumper? What do they call it? Puddle jumper? Or
yeah, private aircraft, private general aviation.
What about getting one of those guys to take you where you need to go? That way you don't have to go to the big old airport and wait in line and then wait around for the plane to come. Lots of waiting involved in airports, mm-hmm. Lots of hassles. You can eliminate all that, pay maybe a little bit more, and have convenience. To me, it's worth it to pay the extra to have that convenience. But unfortunately, the FAA is saying that's illegal. The companies that are trying to provide those services, like Flight Now, The companies that are sort of like the Uber of the airlines that will connect you with people willing to fly you somewhere, they are suing. Flight Now is suing the FAA. So we talked about that. Maybe you are a private pilot. Maybe you have some experience in that range and you are paying close attention to this. Would love to hear from you. Or maybe you're somebody who thinks the FAA needs to crack down even harder on these private pilots because, well, terrorism. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. Let's go to Dave Ridley, and then we'll continue the Turkey Club story that we started, because we ended up talking about Amtrak and bad customer service that Chris experienced on Amtrak very recently. So we'll continue with that. Dave Ridley, though, first in, where are you, Dave? Colorado?
Yes, that's correct.
Welcome, sir. Go ahead with your thoughts.
If I change my name every time I'm in a different state, I guess that could get confusing. So I just identified myself by name. I had sort of promised, or at least indicated, that I would try to, you know, every time the Croatian or Serbian police commit some new abuse against the Liberlanders, I would bring up a new atrocity committed by those people just 20 years ago.
Yes.
I wanted to do that tonight.
So recently four people were arrested last week. Has there been something newer than that?
No, it was just I saw it on the Free Talk Live feed from last week, and I haven't actually listened to that broadcast. But I went directly to the Liberland Press website, and it got the impression, correct me if I'm wrong, was it mostly Croatian police doing the bad deeds this time again?
Yeah, it was all Croatian police. They arrested four people, one of whom, his name was Krom. He actually called the show. He's from Brazil originally, and he was very difficult for the police to arrest. He actually grabbed the Liberland flag and waded out into the waters of the Danube River, making it so that the looked like fairly portly police officer had to go for a little swim in order to actually capture Krom. So they made it a little more difficult on the cops this time, but they ultimately did effectively kidnap them and are now holding them. And well, they had to release Krom, actually, because apparently there's a rule in Croatia that if you can't get a hearing within 24 hours, you have to be released on bail. And because he speaks Portuguese, he demanded that he have a hearing in his native language, and they couldn't get a Portuguese speaker translator there within 24 hours, so they had to let him go. Nice. But he's still stuck in Croatia. He can't leave the country.
The picture of his arrest looked pretty brilliant, too. Like, he's really thought some of this stuff through, or he's brilliant on the spot. But
yeah.
Anyway, I just wanted to bring up just another random massacre by Croatian forces. This one was in January 15th, 1993, in Croatian-controlled Bosnia, which was basically being, you know, attacked by the Croatian government. This is the Dusha Massacre, quote, from Wikipedia, quote, "The Dusha Massacre was a massacre of Bosniak, a.k.a. Bosnian Muslim, women and children committed by Croats in the village of Dusha near Gornji Vakuf. It was committed on January 15th. Around 10 civilians were killed in an artillery attack. This massacre is also referred to as the Forgotten Massacre, as there is still no single conviction against the perpetrators. After the massacre, Croat soldiers entered the village to celebrate it, captured the rest of the villagers, transported men to the camps in Prozor, Trnovača, and Paloc, and raise the village to the ground," unquote. Nothing, but, you know, it seems like Croatia is unreformed if it's doing these kinds of things to people that aren't even in territory that it claims. At least it was claiming parts of Bosnia, right? You know, at least they were open about it to some extent, or at least they were claiming to want indirect control. But this Liberland, they admit that it's not part of Croatia, and they're not laying claim to it.
Right.
At least they haven't previously laid claim to it, but I would say that the actions of "we're going to arrest you for coming here" is kind of like laying claim.
Yeah.
I mean,
I was just looking at their statement on their ministry of, I guess, their foreign ministry, and they were saying that it's sort of like a demilitarized zone between them and Serbia, and it's something that they have a legitimate interest in, but they didn't say they were laying claim to it.
Well, I imagine they didn't. There was actually, when Krom was on the phone, he used, I'm so sorry, I don't remember what it was, but he used a term that he said it was specific to the EU, that it was some sort of international EU land, like an international territory, that it wasn't Croatia, that it wasn't Serbia, but it was some kind of other word. And I'm sorry, I know I wrote it down at the time, but I don't have it in front of me right now. It was a word I'd never heard before, and nobody on the show had ever heard it. It was obviously something that people in Europe would be familiar with, but we wouldn't necessarily over here, suggesting that Croatia was arguing that they were enforcing international agreements, basically, that this is some sort of international territory, part of the EU, and that they were doing that on behalf of this international treaty.
Maybe terra nullius?
Yeah, and you wonder, no, why does Serbia not feel like it has to do the same thing? Why does Serbia feel so comfortable, you know, taking so much less action against the Liberlanders?
Dave, thanks for calling tonight, man. Appreciate hearing from you. By the way, great video on the Ridley Report, ridleyreport.com. There's a video where some cop tells you to stop recording him, and you just assert your rights, and you stand there and you tell this cop, "Well, you're going to have to arrest me then if you don't want to be recorded."
I almost couldn't believe I was saying that, and I almost couldn't stop myself. It was just like it was a reflex, you know.
Yeah, it totally is, and I just loved it because you called his bluff. The dude totally backed down after you said that back to him, and it was such a short encounter. But it was really brilliant. People who you know, who aren't familiar with you yet should definitely go check you out at RidleyReport.com. And thanks for the call tonight. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. So, the Turkey Club. Chris, you're on the Amtrak train going down to Pennsylvania, and you're hungry.
I'm hungry.
You stop in. Yeah, you go to the guy tending the bar or whatever, the food truck.
Yep. He's, like I said, he's leaning up against the wall in there. Just chilling out, just relaxing. I ask, and to be clear and full disclosure, it was a turkey wrap, not a club. So let's get our facts straight here. And I said, I would like the turkey BLT club, please.
I thought it was a wrap.
See, now you got me messed up. I even said, please. And he literally just stared at me. Mm. And I was just really uncomfortable because usually I'm used to servers providing some sort of response, a little feedback to me to say, okay, I've got your order. He just stared at me, and I again said, I like that turkey BLT wrap, please. He said, I heard you the first time, and that just blew me away. I'm like, excuse me?
Okay.
He said, well, most people order more than one thing.
Oh, he was waiting for you to go on.
Yes.
Is that the idea?
Yes. Most people order more than one thing, and I don't move until I get the whole order.
Okay.
And I lost it on the inside. I was speechless. I didn't know what to say to this guy. I'm like, in my mind, I'm going, really? You're kidding me. But that was his attitude. And after he said that, then he shuffled over and he got me my turkey BLT wrap.
But was it good?
It was fine. It was all prepackaged. It's not like they have to cook
anything.
So he just
grabs it out of a damn refrigerator.
They have nothing there they have to cook. Yeah, they just grabbed it and said, here you go. Here it is.
Wow. Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. What's going on over in Greece? Probably not good things, considering the price of Bitcoin. I'm not saying the price of Bitcoin is tied to what's happening in Greece, but it sure has been coincidental that it's been going up over the last few weeks. Bitcoin crashing through $300, now over $310 per Bitcoin tonight. There's more coming up on Free Talk Live.
Are you suffering with hearing loss? Are you sick of people constantly complaining that your TV is too loud? Are you tired of asking people to speak up? Would you like to hear more clearly, but you don't want to wear a hearing aid that makes you look old? Then you need to try Listen Clear, a life-changing breakthrough precisely designed by top audio engineers to fit your ear almost invisibly. And you can adjust Listen Clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are, and whatever you're doing. And now we're extending our in-home trial to let you try Listen Clear risk-free for a full 45 days, with free shipping. We'll even give you free batteries for life. Call now, 1-800-956-9829. Listen Clear is lightweight and completely hassle-free, and it's practically invisible. Call for your extended 45-day in-home trial with free shipping and free batteries for life. For free information, call now. 1-800-956-9829. That's 1-800-956-9829. 1-800-956-9829.
For over 5 years, you've been hearing about the Berkey guy, so you may know a few things about him. For example, you are well aware of the superior quality and effectiveness of Berkey water filters and accessories. But did you know the Berkeys have had independent lab tests done to prove just how effective they are? It's true, and he can email you the test results. Just visit GoBerkey.com. You may also know that the Berkey guy has helped tens of thousands of people get better prepared. Now here's something you may not know. GoBerkey.com has amazing specials and deals all the time on a wide variety of survival and preparedness products, most ready to ship same day. Visit the Berkey guy at GoBerkey.com and be sure to click the red Products on Sale Now button. You can always call toll-free 877-886-3653. Again, that's 877-886-3653. GoBerkey.com, home of the Berkey guy.
This alert just came in. This special announcement is for business owners and leaders of organizations who've been waiting for the right time to build. General Steel has made it impossible to wait any longer with rock-bottom prices that could save you thousands. That's right. General Steel, America's leader in pre-engineered structures, is offering buildings at prices you will never see again. Don't miss these prices. A 50 by 100 for under $30,000. You heard right. That's 5,000 square feet under $30,000. Manufacturers, if you need a larger building, try a 100 by 100 commercial building for $129,000. You can't afford to rent with these prices. Imagine a 70 by 100 foot church building for under $69,000. With the economy improving and interest rates still at historic lows, you can't afford to wait.
Call 800-917-8251. 800-917-8251. 800-917-8251.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. It's the live Sunday edition. Of course, you can join us here to bring up anything you want to discuss at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You get online at all, you need to protect yourself. Your internet service provider isn't going to do it for you. In fact, they're probably collecting information about you, specifically the websites you're visiting, maybe even the search terms you're entering, keeping those logs in some cases as long as several years, maybe selling that information out to other corporations or giving it over to the government. You can stop that from happening by encrypting your data connection with ProXPN. You go to proxpn.com/FTL. And you can get started with their free app for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, Linux. You get started with that and get connected, and your internet is encrypted, which means there's no more prying and spying. Criminals can't sniff out your Wi-Fi packets if they're encrypted. Wi-Fi packets makes life a lot more difficult for people that want to get your personal information. ProXPN.com/FTL. Plus, with their premium account, you get unlimited bandwidth. Servers around the world that you can access, you can privately torrent, get past regionally blocked websites, and ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits. You get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. And when you use code FTL50, that's FTL like Free Talk Live, and 50 as in 50% off, you will get 50% off the regular monthly price when you buy an annual account with that code FTL50. It breaks the price down to around $5 per month, and that price is good for the lifetime of your account. No matter which premium account you choose. So go to proxpn.com/FTL and use code FTL50 to get a great discount on privacy that is priceless. It's Ian and Chris in the studio tonight. We've got Carl in Atlantic City listening to WPG. Hello, Carl.
Hi. You know, I want to bring back some old news from Friday when they took that racist Confederate flag off the South Carolina out in front of that place. You know, now there'll be no more white-on-black crime. That's all over, because every time that flag flew and waved, it was a signal for white people to kill black people. But, you know, I don't believe that. I think it was big pharma, because it seems a lot of these young men that do this are on, you know, pharmaceutical drugs. And I got a question for you. What flag do we got to take down then black people won't kill black people? Is there any flag we can take down?
What flag can you take down to stop black people from killing black people?
Yeah.
It's a really good question.
Yeah, I don't understand the question, really. I mean, people kill people for all kinds of reasons, and I imagine
right.
most of them don't include flags today.
Right, right. I agree with you wholly. It was that flag should have stayed up. That flag didn't kill anybody. That flag didn't inspire anybody to kill anybody either.
You're talking about the flag in South Carolina. I mean, apparently it had been flying for quite a long time and was relatively, you know, unobtrusive to people, but now all of a sudden it's become an issue, and I can understand why. I mean, there are certainly some racist connotations that come along with
yeah.
it. So I get that, and I think Mark would make the point if he were here that, well, it doesn't really make sense for a flag of a nation that doesn't exist anymore to be flying over a state capital.
That's a good point.
So there's that.
Yeah. Well, the flag float was on the dome since the centennial, so that went up on 1961, and then he put it out.
I think we should be consistent, though. If we're going to bring down that flag, let's bring them all down. Let's take down all U.S. flags, all state flags.
Yeah.
Let's get rid of the idea of nations. Let's get rid of the idea of borders and actually have some freedom. How about that?
I like that.
Yeah, because then you couldn't blame it on any flag because there wouldn't be any.
There you go, Carl. Thanks for your call tonight. Appreciate it. Toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE.
And there is another target.
What's that?
Not just the Confederate flag, but the fleur-de-lis. Have you heard of this?
I don't know what that is.
Okay.
What is that?
Are you familiar with the New Orleans Saints?
That's a football team.
It's a football team, and
okay.
you know they have that sort of stylized logo on the side. That is known
the
as fleur-de-lis? A fleur-de-lis.
Okay.
Fleur-de-lis is seen all over Louisiana, and it's just a very popular symbol.
What does it stand for?
Well, it's just a symbol. But how it's been used in the past,
okay.
When a slave would run away in the South, this was customary in Louisiana, they would be branded with a fleur-de-lis.
Oh.
That was sort of your strike one. Strike two, they would cut your hamstring.
Oh, my.
So, allegedly, I think at this point we really need to either abolish the New Orleans Saints or get rid of that helmet. Following the same logic, it's just silly. But I'll try to pull up the article, but there was an article about a group that's saying we need to do away with the fleur-de-lis. Which is really a very popular symbol in New Orleans. It's
yeah, I bet it is.
It's all over the place.
And I guess you could look at that saying that you could look at it in two ways, right? Like you could look at it that this fleur-de-lis is a relic of the days of chattel slavery, and this is what the white masters would brand upon people, and it's a horrible symbol. But maybe it could also, by flying it, mean that you're an escaped slave.
Yeah.
I don't know. I guess you could look at it in two different ways. And of course, that's the same thing with the rebel flag, is it can be looked at in different ways. Like all symbols, they mean different things to different people. Our toll-free number here tonight, if you want to join us, we're on the live Sunday edition, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've also got the latest from Greece coming up here tonight, as apparently, according to some news reports, they are getting closer to actually coming to an agreement with their creditors. Of course, in case you haven't heard, Greece is in serious financial difficulty at the moment, owing over, I think, $300 billion to the IMF and I think 19 Eurozone nations or 18 of them or something like that. And they have not been making their payments. They defaulted a couple of weeks ago, and the banks went on what they call a bank holiday and essentially restricted capital. There was these capital controls, as they're called, that have been put down on Greece. And those capital controls are going to continue, according to one story. And some of the Greeks are pretty upset at the fact that now the country's government is talking about accepting austerity measures, which is the reason why they were elected in the first place, was to not accept the austerity measures. So there may be Molotov cocktails being thrown in the streets before you know it again in Greece from the angry people there. Let's go first to your calls and thoughts, though. Lewis is in Virginia. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, Lewis.
Hey, man. What's going on? You know what? I just turned to you guys' channel. And, I heard the guy say, what kind of flag can we take down for black folks in the black folks? Look here, man. Let me just be frank. You know, it don't matter if you got a flag flying, a flag not flying. You know, people gonna always discriminate. They gonna always be racist. That's just how this world is, man.
That's true.
You know, And you just can't get mad at people who talk like that. Because, really, that's just who they are, man. You know, and that guy probably worked with black people, Chinese people, man. I'm from the Bay Area, baby, and we got it all out there. Man, you know, you can't come out there with that racist stuff, man, because it's a big old melting pot, man.
Which Bay Area? There's a lot of Bay Areas. Which one?
Out there in California.
San Francisco?
You know, I'm from... Yeah, man, that's where I'm from, man. And, you know, it's the home of all the champions. Kenny Stabler, all that, man, you know. Come on, man.
Lewis, I appreciate your perspective, man.
Yeah, man. Hey, man, you guys, y'all take care of yourself.
Drive safe out there,
you
Lewis.
Too. Be safe.
Yep, thanks for the call tonight. He's on the road. 855-450-FREE. One of our professional drivers out there making America work. I appreciate that. Thank you for your service. 855-450-FREE. That's our toll-free number here. And you can bring up anything you want on this live Sunday edition. We'll talk more about Greece on the way. And you can also bring up anything. It's Free Talk Live.
By now you know that wireless technology like cell phones do in fact pose dangers to the health and privacy of everyone. Lockheed Pocket's wide range of products are unmatched in providing the protection you deserve. No scare tactics, just common sense. LockheedPocket.com offers quality American-made options to alleviate and eliminate these invisible dangers. Learn more at LockheedPocket.com or call 888-315-9618. LockheedPocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey System. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting goberkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com. On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas
of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. The live Sunday edition continues here with me, Ian.
And Chris.
And our toll-free number for you to join us and bring up anything you want to discuss is 855-450-FREE. It is that easy. Also, it's even better when you call us on Skype. Skype sounds great almost all the time. And we have a better router here in the studio now, so I feel like we've had a more quality Skype connection ever since making that change. So it's better than ever to call on Skype now. Skype username is lrn.fm. So join us there. You can talk about your travel. We were talking about travel restrictions, specifically preventing the FAA preventing these air pooling companies, air ride sharing, essentially, from existing at this moment. There's an active court case where one of those companies, FlightNow, is suing the FAA. Maybe you've got some experience as a private pilot and you'd like to share your thoughts. You're welcome to join us here at 855-450-FREE. Or maybe you want to tell us a terrible customer service story from Amtrak. Or anywhere, for that matter. I mean, you can bring up anything. This is Free Talk Live, and we're going to continue with your calls and thoughts. Then, coming up, we'll talk more about what's happening over in Greece, where the banks have stayed closed for a second week. First, it was going to be a one-day bank holiday, which turned into a five-day bank holiday, which has now turned into a two-week-long bank holiday. And so we'll give you the latest on what's happening there. But Bruce is with us in Fairview, North Carolina, listening to WWNC in Asheville. Hey, Bruce.
Happy bank holiday, hey, Bruce.
Happy bank holiday. Yeah, well, I got kind of a pet peeve.
Yeah,
you know,
sure.
I live out in the mountains in a log cabin. I threw away my computer. I feel really great about it.
Wow.
I'm off the grid. And I love it. I mean, if I ever need it, does everybody got a computer or I go to the library?
There you go.
But my peeve is when you go to, when I go up here in the mountains, when I go to pay my phone bill, my TV bill, anything, they charge you $5 to $15 to pay over the phone.
Isn't that ridiculous?
It is. Yep. I mean, you know, you're buying their service. You go to, you call them up to pay them with your debit card, and they say, well, it's $15 unless you go to the, you know.
Go to the website.
What about cutting them a check? I mean, they'll still take a check, won't
actual,
they?
If you send it to them in the mail, but. Sometimes I thought it was just, what's the difference between a check and debit, you know?
Well, here's the argument. So let me just see if I can play devil's advocate here, because I see where you're coming from, and it's frustrating, and banks are doing this now, too, where if you call for customer service, they might charge you for that. Again, it depends on the bank, so your mileage may vary. But the argument is basically, oh, well, you need this service of paying over the phone. It requires a human being or whatever to talk to you, and so therefore we need to pay those customer service reps. Are you talking to someone physically, or are you just punching in a number in an automated system?
Talking physically.
Right. So mm-hmm. That's it. They're having to justify paying that person extra, whereas they wouldn't have to pay a person to talk to you if you were just cutting them a check or if you were going through their online payment system. So, I mean, that's the justification for it, and they're going to argue that this is a way they can keep costs down instead of building in the cost of running the customer service center into everyone's bill. They just bill it directly to the people who use it. So it kind of makes sense from that perspective.
From that perspective, I guess so. But still, like to pay off, to pay a payment on, not Home Depot, on Lowe's, they charge you $15 over the phone.
That is crazy.
Yeah, then, you know, you got to go to the store or send in a check. So
yeah, I would say, you know, checks are really out, you know, kind of an out-of-date payment technology, but they are a way to avoid a lot of fees in general. So it's still worth it to have a checking account and a checkbook for situations like that. Plus, a lot of times if you're paying with credit card, you'll also see credit card fees added in there as well. So some places, especially governments, the governments do this all the time where they'll, you know, some sort of fee you have to pay to a government and they'll say, well, we'll take your credit card, but it'll be a 5% fee on
right.
top. And that's because the credit card companies are charging them that 3 to 5% or whatever. And so they're trying to make that back.
It gets really weird. There's a whole industry that's popped up around this too. They're basically collectors of money for a particular business, and what they can do is they can rent out their whole call center to process these calls and make these payments and things like that. So the company saves money because they don't have to do any of that.
So they're renting somebody else to handle the calls, which would mean that company that's handling the calls could be doing multiple companies at once.
Oh, and they are. Yeah. So if you happen to even if you log into some, like when I pay my electric bill through Liberty Utilities, I actually go to a company called Bill Matrix, and they're the ones that process it. And they have, it's free if you do it online, but it costs money if I talk to them on the phone. They're trying to steer things online, and I get that. It's more cost efficient for everybody. But for some people like you who just choose not to be online, then you do incur some financial hit for that.
Yeah, well, I guess, like you said, I could always send a check. But
there you go.
I don't know. I would think $2 would be something someone...
Well, you're not running the business, right? I mean, you're not the one who's who's putting the call center together. Hey, Bruce, thanks for the call, man. I appreciate you calling from out there in Asheville. Thank you, sir. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. At least when you're off the grid, you can still listen to the radio and call us on the telephone. So thank you for participating. Let's go to John in Des Moines. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Chris. Hello, John.
Whoa. Yeah, I'd like to talk to you about this woman that I heard of down in, I believe it was Texas, that got her kids taken away. What it was she had cannabis oil in, and one of the teachers at the school heard her kids, you know, they were doing a drug-free deal. And
oh, man.
Her kid said something about, well, my mom uses cannabis oil. Well, teacher, I guess, ended up calling the cops, and they ended up going to her house. They didn't have a search warrant yet. She pulled up, and then they're telling her, well, she can't go in her house because they're waiting on a search warrant.
Wow.
And basically, her rights were totally taken away from her. And the reason I'm calling is I just kind of wonder, you know, here the government is wanting to do all this here stuff. Why isn't there a big fine, like $1 million fine, for every time the government messes up as far as going against the Constitution?
Well, brother, I mean, they're always going against the Constitution, right? So that's nothing new. And, of course, they're going to argue that, well, it's cannabis oil. It's illegal. It's not legal to have medical cannabis in Texas or whatever. And so that's their argument.
Well, this was in Kansas. That's where it was.
Oh, in Kansas.
My bad.
Well, I imagine it's illegal in Kansas still as well.
She had just moved from Colorado. She has Crohn's disease.
Why would she do something like that?
Yeah.
The poor lady. I'm not laughing at her. I'm just laughing out of frustration. It's really it's really sad, and it's terrible. And, you know, there is a takeaway that I think people can learn from this experience, and that is, hey, don't send your kids to government school. That was really the big mistake. Well, first of all, it's a mistake to leave Colorado if you've got some sort of sickness that you're using medical cannabis for. I mean,
Absolutely. Why
go to a place like Kansas? I don't understand
Now, this was cannabis oil, sir. It wasn't the plant itself.
That's correct. It's still illegal, though. It's anything that's, you know, THC-based is going to be a criminal charge. So I guess, you know, she wasn't arrested, was she? She just had her kids taken away?
Yeah, she wasn't arrested. No files were ever charged against her, but they took her kids away.
It's outrageous.
From her.
I'll tell you, if this is a story I'm thinking of, and I read one on this, too, I think it's talking about CBD or...
So it's not even THC oil.
Exactly. It's cannabidiol, or if that's a correct pronunciation.
I don't know how you pronounce it. But yeah, CBD is one of the other active chemicals in cannabis. And it is very useful for treating certain things medically.
Very much so.
But it won't get you high.
No, not at all. So we've been dealing with this a little bit with my girlfriend's parents because, again, he has cancer. He's in Pennsylvania, has zero access to anything. Mm. And we've actually got him past that sort of generational hump of saying, yes, if it would help me, I would be willing to try marijuana or THC.
Has he tried it?
CBD. Unofficially, he may have had a puff or two. I think that did occur.
Hey, John, thanks for the call tonight, man. I'm sorry to hear the story. It's awful. The best thing you can do if you're a parent is get your kids out of government school. I mean, had the child not been in government school, no one with an authority mindset would have heard him or her say, oh yeah, my mom's got cannabis oil. So that would have solved the problem right there. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. This happens all the time where in, like, DARE class, the DARE officer will ask the class, kids, do any of your parents have marijuana at home?
Better tell us.
855. We just want to help them,
do
kids.
The right thing.
855-450-FREE. You can share your story with us. It's Free Talk Live.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
And now, a touching moment. Well, staying in touch with Geico.
Just the other night, as I gazed up into the sky, I saw a shooting star. In that moment, I made a wish that Geico would be available 24/7, by phone, on the web, or with the Geico app. After that, I realized my wish had already come true. So basically, I had just wasted a perfectly good wish. Then I started to think about dolphins and felt better right away.
Geico. Anywhere, anytime.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Keenvention is coming up October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. Explore Keen, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel from 2013 on. This year, Activist of the Year Daryl W. Perry and Chris Cantwell will be keynoting. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenevention this October 30th through November 1st. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or pay with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallow Keene Costume Dance Party. Reserve your tickets now at keenevention.info. Visit keenevention.info for more speaker announcements or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenevention.info. Keenevention.info.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Welcome back. More Free Talk Live continuing now here on the live Sunday edition of the show. With you tonight, it's Ian.
And Chris.
And want to invite you to purse.freetalklive.com. How would you like to get 20-25% off of Amazon purchases? anything you want to buy. 20% off, easy. You can even get more than that. I've gotten 25% off, and that was also pretty darn easy to get through purse.freetalklive.com. You do have to use Bitcoin, however, to get that discount. That's how it works. You pay with Bitcoin, and you save big. And it's very simple. You can go to purse.freetalklive.com. They've got a nice little intro video that'll explain to you how it works. And when you sign up at purse.freetalklive.com, which you can do right now, even if you don't know what you want to buy yet, you can just go and get your account set up. Whenever you do it through purse.freetalklive.com, Free Talk Live will, from that point forward, get a very small portion of any purchase that you make through purse.freetalklive.com. I'm a big fan of Purse. I've been using it since before we started talking about them, you know, officially on the air. I've used it probably 24 times now. And they give you a little tally of how much you've saved by using Purse. I've saved $500+.
Well, it also depends on what you bought your Bitcoin at. If you bought your Bitcoin at $200 and now it's at $300, you're actually saving a whole lot more too.
Well, there is that as well. I mean, if you just go out and buy Bitcoin for the purpose of spending it at Purse, you're doing great, right?
Yeah.
Like if you go to expresscoin.com, you pay 3% for your Bitcoin there, and then you go and you save 20 or 25% at Purse. That's awesome. I mean, it's just unbeatable. Purse.freetalklive.com. David is in Albuquerque. You're on Free Talk Live listening to Kiva. Hey, David.
Hey, how's it going?
Welcome, sir. Go ahead.
It was the first time listening, first time calling into any type of radio station, and I listened for a little bit, heard about the different stories in and out, you know. So I guess this is kind of a personal topic for me because I guess I'm just going to say it. I am a registered sex offender living in Albuquerque, New Mexico, and I really don't understand the world around me when I'm trying to apply for work and no one will hire me because of this. I have to go down to my local sheriff's office, get a form to take to them, and the employer looks at the form, looks back at me, and says,
see ya.
Right.
So, you know, wow. I have two beautiful daughters, a 14-year-old, 10-year-old, and a 7-year-old autistic son. I'm just knee-high... You know, don't know what to do.
How long have you had this albatross around your neck? How long has this been for you now?
I was convicted in 2008 in March.
And did you go to prison?
I went to CCDC for about 6 months, yeah.
What is that, the local jail?
Mm-hmm.
Correct, sir.
Okay. And now you're a registered sex offender for life?
Correct, sir.
What was the charge?
Statutory sexual seduction.
Statutory sexual seduction. So sex with somebody under the age of 18?
Correct, sir.
And is that the legal age in New Mexico? Is it 18 or 16 or what?
I believe it is 17, you know, but I have a beautiful girlfriend here, so I don't know the specifics on that one. I apologize.
It's okay.
Sorry to hear about that, man. Yeah, I don't know if you want to tell us more details about the case. Obviously, that could be an upsetting thing to go through. But, you know, was your argument that it was essentially a consensual relationship? But, you know, did she lie about her age or what happened?
Well, no. She didn't lie about her age. And that's like, it's a very personal story. And I had a very hard upbringing. It's too long of a story to get into. And to make a long story short, my mom passed away in 1990, the day before Halloween. And my upbringing changed dramatically after that. And yeah, you know, I'm a registered sex offender now, and recently, you know, I've just been feeling something, and I saw something, and I'm going through this mystery medical thing that nobody can diagnose me with, and I got a sister, a nurse in Corona, California. She won't answer me. No one will talk to me. My dad's laughing. You know, I can't get into it, but so much stuff, but I have my 14-year-old daughter, my 10-year-old daughter, and my 7-year-old son, and I don't, you know, I'm trying my hardest to get out of here, you know, with the statistics saying that more than 90% of registered sex offenders do not offend, you know, and we aren't even given a second chance. We're publicly humiliated daily.
It's terrible.
You know? And not only that, but our kids are and our parents are.
So you have custody of your kids. So obviously the state isn't concerned about, you know, you doing something with them, but yet that's still not good enough for you to be wiped off the registry. So people treat you as though you're a clear and present danger to anybody that's around you, even though you've got your own kids with you.
Correct, sir. And like, yeah, I have my son all the time, but my daughters are with another woman, you know, and I see him every other week, you know, and like we have an open relationship. I have no court order, nothing. I help out my daughters. Like, and that's like anybody who gets to know me, for me, I'm a father who loves his children, who does everything he can every day and hopes to and prays to God that I can make it through another day. Because this medical thing, like I have a pancreatitis attacks. I've been in the hospital a lot. and a lipase of 2,115, you know, like, it's no joke.
What, let's see, so you're on this registered sex offender list. Everybody's turning you down for a job. How are you putting food in your mouth? What are you doing to make ends meet?
I'm pretty much living off my father, and he's going broke. There's mold in our house that we can't treat. It's been raining a lot over here, monsoon season, and yeah, my dad's going down, slipping down this financial hole, you know, not exactly like Greece, but, you know, like, you know, we're all experiencing some trouble in some type of form, you know, and it just all feels pressure and stressful. And I want to do something, you know, even with my medical stuff, I'm trying to work. I just got back from the gas station the street.
Here's a question just for, I mean, look, I don't know how hard it is to go through this. It must be really awful, but what about working under the table? What about, right, you know, mowing lawns or, you know, doing something where you can just go and talk to somebody and you're not officially getting hired as an employee?
Right.
What about contract work? What about, we talked about Uber and Lyft earlier tonight.
Under the table.
That's like, not under the table. What's that?
I'm sorry to interrupt you. Under the table, that was a fourth-degree felony for me.
Really?
If I do not notify the local sheriffs of where I work in place of work, you know, and notify them of their location, and I don't take this permission form in pretty much to who hired me, because I have to get hired first, and then I go to my sheriff's office, and then I have to get a form.
But if you come to my front door and I say I need my lawn mowed and I'll give you $20,
right,
and you go and do that, I haven't hired you in any sort of employee sort of manner. Are you saying that the cops need to know that you're mowing somebody's lawn?
Well, when I went through my treatment in Las Vegas, Nevada, it was through a great treatment program, and it did change my life. You know, like I said, I had a hard upbringing, and he had a saying. He said, "How safe do you want to make yourself?" And being a father, you know, that transcends to being, you know, how safe do I want my children? And so when you say that and you say it like that, you know, like I really just question, how safe would I be? You know, all it takes is for them to find out that I'm on the registry. And if they have a sour taste in their mouth, you know, and they want to do something, they can do
call
something.
The cops.
So
yeah.
Exactly. And that's how, like, stressed and far-headed I'm reaching, you know, because that is a fourth degree felony if I go do that.
Okay, but wait a minute. This is what I understand. I mean, if you are running your own business, they can't prohibit a sex offender from starting their own business, can they?
No, they can't. I've been.
So you're not working. You're not working for somebody. Yes, you're doing a job for somebody, but you're working for yourself. When you go out there and you mow, people's lawns for a living or whatever other manual labor, and you're not working for someone else who's employing you, you are working for yourself as a contractor for those people. And it would seem to me that if you're working for yourself, maybe you could inform them of that. Of like, hey, I'm mowing lawns for a living. This is my business name. This is, you know, how you can get in touch with me. That way you can sort of cover your butt a little bit there and inform them of that. I would say that might be worth a closer look at. I mean, look at the, like I said, I'm not familiar with the regulations, how strict they are. I imagine they are very strict in a lot of different ways. But they can't tell you can't work for yourself. I mean, I guess they could, but it seems pretty shocking that they would do that.
I would definitely look into that.
Yeah.
And
that would be my choice. And I wonder what kind of background checks Uber and Lyft do on their potential drivers. I imagine they do some because they don't want people who've got bad traffic records.
But no, Uber does.
Yeah. But that might be worth a try too. Like, yeah, see if you can get contractor kind of work like Uber and Lyft, because you're not an employee for them. You would be your own boss, essentially, and you sort of
subcontract.
Yeah, you're just kind of plugging into their systems. That's the best I got for you, David. I wish you the best of luck, and I'm sorry to hear about your story, and it's certainly you're not alone out there. Thank you for the call tonight, and good luck. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. And then, you know, those guys in the sex offender registry, a lot of them are there for crimes that aren't actual crimes, in my opinion. You know, like, you can get put on a sex offender registry for public urination.
And
in some places.
What drives me nuts about it is, I'm going to generalize here, but it tends to be more fundamentalist people that are pushing very, very hard for these laws.
Like Christian fundamentalists?
Yeah, without going there. Yeah, but absolutely, that say, you know, we must do everything we possibly can to protect the children. Hmm. No punishment is too harsh for these types of people.
Yeah, yet, it is too harsh, because if you take away a person's chance to be who they want to be, to make a living for themselves.
Well, that's my point.
They're going to go towards a life of crime. I mean, if you can't make a living legally, you're going to find something criminal to do, aren't you?
Right. But they'll embrace all that on one side. On the other side, they will absolutely deny a person a right to a second chance, which is also a very Christian thing to do. That's what drives me nuts.
It's stuff. Very unchristian to deny someone a second chance. 855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number here, and you can join us on the radio waves. We've got hour number three on the way. Plenty of time for you. We can talk about Greece and what's happening over there or whatever's on your mind. You want to talk about the sex offenders? You're welcome to join that conversation, too. This is Free Talk Live. More coming up.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
A few days ago, Brooke Tudine posted an inspirational quote on her wall that got 17 likes and 3 comments. Thumbs up, Brooke. Geico also wants to make a comment. In just 15 minutes, you could save hundreds of dollars on your car insurance by switching to Geico. And nothing says inspiration better than saving money. Well, except for those posters that say things like teamwork, excellence, and make it happen. Hashtag keep climbing. Hashtag savings.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With 4, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, July 12th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.61 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,163 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $309. Antiwar.com reports officials have confirmed the Iran nuclear talks were extended until Monday, the latest in a series of short extensions that followed up the initial June 30th deadline. There was a breakthrough in the talks last Saturday, but since then the official line is that things are going poorly, with claims of the U.S. changing its demands at the last minute and reports of shouting matches in the middle of the talks by top officials on all sides. At the same time, Israeli media are reporting a done deal in the talks, saying that there are plans to sign the pact early next week, and that the deal was reached after the U.S. made some capitulations over the past 2 to 3 weeks. Israeli reports are typically negative about the prospect of a deal, of course, but the report of a deal does make sense, as the Associated Press is reporting President Obama has been clearing out his schedule for the next few days, awaiting news from Vienna. On the other hand, reports from last weekend also suggested a deal was imminent, only to be followed up with reports of changed demands from the U.S. and other Western nations involved in the talks. Throughout all of this, the only official U.S. statement has been threats to walk away from the talks at any moment.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports nearly 80 years after it was founded, U.S. Airways has made reservations for its final flights. The carrier will complete its last two flights in October before the name becomes entirely absorbed into its merger with American Airlines. Flights 496 and 434 will be the final two U.S. Airways flights to take off on the evening of October 16th, according to the airline. Both flights are scheduled to depart Phoenix and San Francisco, respectively, at the exact same minute, but officials said the San Francisco flight will be the last to land in Philadelphia 4 hours later. The Phoenix flight will land in Denver just after midnight local time. American Airlines decided to merge the carrier's reservations into one system on October 17th, which will officially retire the U.S. Airways name. American Airlines executive Maya Liebman said, "At that point, we're going to be one airline for our customers. We will have one website, one mobile app, one set of travel policies, and elite benefits." Another executive said the great news for customers is that after our cutover on October 17th, the travel experience will be seamless.
FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. I trust Coinbase. You should too. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. That's coinbase.fppradio.com.
Reuters reports Washington State took in $65 million in tax revenue from the recreational cannabis market during the first 12 months since it became legal to produce and sell. According to the data released by the Washington State Liquor Control Board, which oversees the distribution of cannabis, the revenue was generated by cannabis sales of more than $260 million from June 2014 to June 2015. Voters in Washington State, as well as in Colorado, approved measures legalizing personal possession and consumption of cannabis in 2012, ushering in the licensing and taxation of retail stores that offer a range of cannabis products. Despite remaining against federal law, possession of small amounts of cannabis is also legal in the District of Columbia, Oregon, and Alaska. In Washington State, customers who are 21 and older are legally allowed to purchase up to 1 ounce of cannabis. They are also allowed to buy up to 16 ounces of cannabis-infused product in solid form or up to 72 ounces of cannabis-infused product in liquid form. Retailers sold more than 23,000 pounds of cannabis of the 31,000 pounds produced in Washington during the year. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Tides are caused by the moon. The moon's gravitational pull also sucks up the feces and urine of the ocean floor, dumping it in the intertidal zones. The tide goes out, revealing pus-filled cysts known as tide pools, while the moon itself remains hypocritically pristine. Crabs are one of the many disgusting denizens of intertidal pools. They feed on feces and corpses with their demonic mouths. Scuttling hither and thither, they compete relentlessly for the juiciest excrement. Finding a walrus turd is truly nirvana for these abhorrent beasts. After accumulating too much filth to move, crabs bathe themselves in the ocean. Waste floods off the crab's exoskeleton and back into the tide pools as the cycle of shit begins anew.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You're invited here to join us on this live Sunday edition of the program. With you in the studio tonight, it's Ian
and Chris.
We will take your calls about anything you want to discuss. We've also got Skype. You can Skype in here. It's the username lrn.fm. That's lrn.fm on Skype, or toll-free number 855-450-FREE. What's going on over in Greece? We haven't really covered it in as much detail in the last week as we did the first very dramatic week, where there was a deadline for a $1.7 billion payment on a huge bailout that they've received with like $300+ billion over the last several years. And they missed that deadline. And then there was ultimately a vote where the people of Greece, 61%, I believe, voted no, we do not want to deal with these austerity measures.
No austerity for you.
Which is not a surprise. That was the expected way that vote was going to go, because the proposal had been from the creditors, like, hey, you owe us all this money. Here's how we'll give you some more if you agree to measures X, Y, and Z. And the people of Greece said, nope, we don't want to do austerity. And that's the message that they sent back. And now there's more negotiations going on. The banks have stayed closed for another week. It's now, you know, we're now through two full weeks of so-called bank holidays. There's ridiculous capital controls that have been placed on the country, meaning you can't go to an ATM and pull out more than 60 euro at any given day.
Wow.
You can do it per bank card. So if you've got more than one bank account, you could pull out 120 or whatever. But for, you know, the average person, this is a very restrictive situation. The businesses in Greece are prohibited from sending money outside of the country. That's one of the other capital controls, which is an outrageous restriction on the ability to get business done. And so those are some of the things that have happened over the last couple of weeks. Here's an update on what's going on now, because the proposal, another proposal has been put on the table, or probably more than one, to the Greek government saying, well, you know, here's your next chance. Here's another set of austerity measures that you can agree to get bailed out.
And the Greek government flip-flopped, too. Didn't they come out and say, I know we've recommended to you, the Greek people, that you reject all these austerity measures.
Right.
And then they came out today or yesterday and said, you know, we really think you guys should vote and say that we need these austerity measures.
And the people of Greece, many of them are very angry, according to the story over at Reuters. Greeks accused Germany of trying to humiliate them by making tougher demands for a new bailout deal as the country's fate in the Eurozone hung in the balance ahead of a meeting of European ministers in Brussels on Sunday. That's today. Elected on a promise to get rid of Greece, to rid Greece of austerity, Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras was forced this week to make last-minute concessions to the international creditors for painful austerity measures in the hopes of securing a cash-for-reform deal. But the damage done by months of fractious talks and Tsipras's decision to hold a snap referendum on the bailout terms on July 5th means securing a deal will be tough. Lawmakers, including in Germany, Greece's biggest creditor, are skeptical over whether Athens will carry out the reforms that the Greek people overwhelmingly rejected in the referendum. And they should be skeptical about that, because as Chris Cantwell pointed out to me, we've been talking about this, he's been following it really closely, they should be skeptical that Greece's government is going to follow through with the promise, because the people of Greece are likely to go to the streets and start tipping cars over and setting buildings on fire.
Every time.
So, you know, if you are the prime minister or one of his associates there at the upper levels of the Athens government, then what is your choice going to be? To renege on the deal you made with the creditors to get another bailout? To renege on that deal because there are people going to be throwing Molotov cocktails at your car in your home? I would say that they would likely prefer to not have their houses set on fire, so they're likely going to renege on any kind of agreement that they make.
Yeah, it's incentives, and that's what they're just caught between a rock and a hard place, and the Greek people.
Well, not the finance minister. He resigned last week. I don't know if you heard about that.
Yeah.
He made a smart move. He's getting out of that sinking ship as quickly as he can. Lawmakers are skeptical again whether they will actually follow through, highlighting the reluctance to grant another rescue. Germany's finance ministry floated proposals demanding strong Greek measures or a five-year timeout from the Eurozone. What's at play here is an attempt to humiliate Greece and Greeks or to overthrow the Tsipras government, said Dimitrios Papadimoulos, vice president of the European Parliament and member of Greece's ruling Syriza party. He told that to Mega TV. Their economy pummeled by years of recession, their banks shut, and dozens of businesses closing daily. Some Greeks have vented their anger on figures such as German Chancellor Angela Merkel and Finance Minister Wolfgang Schäuble. The only thing that I care about is not being humiliated by the rest of them, said Panagiotis Tsirkoglou,
nice.
A It's a 44-year-old private sector employee in Athens. He further said, quote, "I don't care if we go to the drachma or whatever. We support the prime minister, whatever decision he makes, but now I feel a little bad. Not with the prime minister, but with Germany's stance. This misanthrope Schäuble, I don't know what he's trying to achieve." Well, he might be trying to achieve getting his money back.
That would be in his interest. The political correctness of this stuff just cracks me up. It's like, we can't spank Greece anymore because we don't do spankings anymore. We can't just lay down the law and say, this is how it's going to be, but we're going to give you a timeout. Yeah. This is like bad 70s parenting. This is great. You're in for a timeout.
Timeout's worked for me.
The other thing that kind of cracked me up in this is you've got another group of leaders, or at least representatives to this whole Greek thing, who are saying that we must preserve Europe. You know,
Greek people are some of the Greek leaders?
No. Some of the leaders in other countries are coming forward and say we must preserve the EU.
Like preserving the Union.
Exactly. It just goes right back to our own civil war. It cracks me
up. But would they be willing to bring, what do they have? Do you have like a European army or something like that? Are they willing to bring troops into Greece to quell the violence in the streets?
Yeah, I think that's been discussed before.
Yeah, I don't think they're going to do that. Can't imagine they would think that keeping the Eurozone together or whatever, or the European Union together, would be worth expending the lives of the people in those countries.
If Greece had any money, you could bet it would happen. But Greece doesn't. Go ahead. You're free to leave.
There was no official reaction from Athens on Sunday about the proposals, although Greek officials in Brussels had said the new German demands proved Berlin did not want a deal. It's clear that certain countries, for reasons which are completely unrelated to reforms in the program, don't want a deal, says a Greek government official. While an agreement had been in sight, a group of countries kept raising credibility issues. They didn't specify, though, what should happen. And, of course, that credibility issue is whether or not the Greek government will actually follow through on the promises. And so far, there's no real evidence to believe that they would. The Eurozone ministers have postponed until today a decision on whether to recommend starting talks on a new loan for Athens. They have sought further commitments first on product market liberalization, labor laws, privatization, state reform, and more defense cuts, plus a promise to pass key laws next week, said officials. What is being proposed is punitive, said Dimitri Sevastakis, a Syriza lawmaker. It is a form of revenge. Back home, Tsipras also faces a battle to contain the fallout from his climb down, with leftist rebels in his own party refusing to back new austerity measures. He could try to quell dissent through a reshuffle or even a snap election. But after 17 lawmakers from the ruling coalition did not support the measures Athens proposed, creditors have grounds to doubt about the implementation. Add to this the outcome of the referendum, said a conservative lawmaker and former minister. So right now, the Greek people are none too happy about the plan to accept austerity measures. The people who are proposing those austerity measures don't really believe that they'll be adhered to. So will this even come to an actual agreement this week? I suspect that in the meantime, the banks are going to remain closed. There is another story saying that Greeks will be facing 6 months of cash controls. Now, that doesn't mean the banks will be closed throughout all of those 6 months. But so far, why would they be reopening the banks? They don't have any money.
Well, and it's not the banks that are doing it, I don't believe. I think it's government coming in and saying, we are closing, you are not allowed. So just like bank holidays occurred during our depression, they just shut them down. That's it.
Yeah, I wonder.
They're not allowed to open.
Yeah, I don't know who. I guess you're probably right. It would be the government making that decision, but I would imagine in tandem with the banks. They don't have money, right? So, like, why would the banks want to open up? Well, then they just have to tell all their customers they can't help them.
Exactly.
So just leave the doors closed. And then, of course, there was the situation where the pensioners, the people who are receiving the equivalent of Social Security or whatever, they actually reopened the banks temporarily to allow the pensioners to come in and withdraw 120 euro to get them through the end of the first week.
Right.
So who knows what's going on in this last week. There's more on the way here about these cash controls. You can share your thoughts at 855-453. It's Free Talk Live.
This is a life-changing message for anyone with sleep apnea who is on the go and tired of dragging around a big, bulky home CPAP device. MiniCPAP.com now offers a portable device that's as small as a soda can and weighs less than a pound. For even more freedom, you can add a battery that's as tiny as a deck of cards. It's called the Transcend Mini CPAP, and right now you can try it risk-free for 21 days by calling 1-800-939-8536.
Transcend is the world's first portable mini CPAP device. It gives you the freedom to sleep in total comfort anywhere you are. Our smallest and most advanced portable design ever, Transcend, is so small and so light you can fit it in your briefcase or purse to use anywhere you go. It's FAA compliant too, so you can even sleep comfortably while flying. Enjoy the freedom to sleep comfortably anywhere. Call MiniCPAP.com now for your 21-day in-home trial. 1-800-939-8536. That's 1-800-939-8536.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
Hey, neighbor, what are you doing digging? You had a heart attack last year.
Oh, I know. I was told no more hard labor.
Then why are you digging?
Well, I've been taking Extendovite. It's been approved to help my heart.
Extendovite? Is that a new drug?
No, not a drug. It's more like an herbal combination made from garlic and cayenne.
Herbal? How can that help?
Well, actually, we've taken herbs for thousands of years. And Extendovite is doing the job for me.
Does your doctor know about Extendovite?
Yeah, my doctor knows, and he said it seems to be working for you, so don't stop taking it. I feel great taking Extendovite. I don't want to stop.
To order, call 1-877-928-8822. That's 1-877-928-8822. Or visit our website at heartdrop.com.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Join us toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Skype in at username lrn.fm. Tonight with you, it's Ian.
And Chris.
We're talking about the latest from Greece, where, according to a story from Reuters, lots of angry Greeks, they're upset. The government they thought they elected to protect them from austerity measures has been sounding like they're going to sell out a little bit here. The Tsipras character, their prime minister there, who seemed like he was staying firm during the initial negotiations a couple of weeks ago that resulted in the people of Greece voting to back him and say no to austerity, sounds like he might be willing to make a deal now.
I want to play poker with that guy.
Which means that the people are going to be a little bit angry about that if he does so, because they elected him to not make that particular deal. And time will tell how this all plays out. The new deal that is being proposed is not yet finalized, And that's because, well, some of the creditors are saying that, well, you know, maybe they're not going to actually follow through. Maybe he's going to say yes. Maybe Tsipras is going to come to the table and agree to these austerity measures in order to get deadlines moved, in order to get another payment. I mean, are they going to give billions more to Greece before the implementation of the austerity measures? If they come to the table and they say, we need X, Y, and Z austerity measures, you need to have control, this and that, whatever, restrict here, are they going to hand over another billion or two or five or 10 or however much it's going to be? Are they going to hand over any more money to Greece before the implementation of those measures? Because if they do, they're insane.
They are. I think they are insane, and I think there'll be some sort of a trickle that goes to them. They'll do a carrot and a stick. I mean, they'll be a little bit now, and if you hit these goals, then you'll get a little bit more and stuff like that. It's kind of tragic. I mean, one of the few things that Greece ever really did well was tourism. I mean, it's one of those sort of cradles of civilization. Yeah. But right now, I mean, you can't. There was an article talking about, you know, all-inclusive resorts, and people are canceling them left and right because there's not going to be any food there. So how do you do an all-inclusive resort when there's no money to buy what you're saying is included?
Well, the article that we shared a couple weeks ago was about these capital controls that mean that businesses cannot send money outside of the country. And apparently there's a lot of businesses that rely on imports in Greece. There's not a whole lot of national sort of industry based on the resources there. And so they're importing a whole lot of product, and they're unable to pay their vendors. And so businesses are shutting their doors. And so why would anyone want to go take a vacation where they can't even go shopping, you know, on Main Street?
Right.
Nobody's open. I mean, I'm saying no one's open, but it's getting pretty bad, apparently. And now they're, according to the story over at thesundaytimes.co.uk, they're now facing 6 months at least of cash controls. Capital controls will stay in place at Greek banks for at least 6 months, according to senior officials in Athens, warning yesterday as the government fights to keep lenders afloat. Leaders of the four main banks and finance ministry officials will meet tomorrow to discuss how to save the banking system from collapse after a run on deposits. Options under consideration include a consolidation of four main banks down to two.
that'll help.
Make everything better.
Absolutely.
The creation of a bad bank to house toxic loans and a possible forced bail-in of depositors. That's another word for a haircut, as they like to call it, which is where they were talking. This was, you know, it was like a week ago that we heard this, that they were talking about doing a 30% cut off the top of any accounts that have more than 8,000 euro in them. So anybody that's been good at saving their money over the years will be punished in this so-called bail-in. We'll talk about some more of their options here, and they're not sounding good at all. Let's go first to Stephen, though, listening in Little Rock. Stephen, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, it's a really interesting story here with Greece. I think this should be an eye-opening example of everyone. It's really the best modern example of the failure of socialism, isn't it?
It's certainly one of them. Venezuela is a pretty darn good example as well. There's a lot of crazy stuff going on there with nationalizing food distribution and the insane currency. What is it? They've set an exchange rate. It's a government-set exchange rate in Venezuela, and that has resulted in just madness economically.
Well, I know there's a lot of anger probably within Greece. They feel like they're losing their identity to this Eurozone, but I have to assume that they're probably a lot better off for having been in the Eurozone, even if that's maybe that's a temporarily kind of on-the-edge sort of thing, because
I would say you could argue they are not better off. I saw some statistics that, and I'm sorry I don't remember exactly what the numbers were, but that there were some serious drops in the country's, I think it was GDP or something like that. There was something that happened. I'm not an economist, but I did see some statistics showing that the Eurozone really hasn't helped Greece.
Really? I would have kind of assumed that this sort of downward arc for Greece was already in place before they were a member of the larger group there, but maybe not.
I suspect you're right. I think that Greece has probably been propped up. So I'm not saying better, but
they've definitely been propped up. That much is true.
Well, that's the whole thing.
Yeah. That doesn't mean they're better off, though.
In government talk, though, being propped up and still being alive is being better off.
Sure, but for the people.
The people keep selecting the same sort of populist type of leaders that tell them that they don't have to, like, pay back these loans, you know. I think it's they haven't done themselves any favors, apparently, really, is what I'm getting at.
No, and I think you're exactly right. And, you know, this is socialism and communism writ large. This is what you get when you go down these paths. And from an economics point of view, it was predictable years ago, just like Venezuela. And that's one that I've followed for the last 4 or 5 years, just based on a couple of headlines to say, okay, they're saying that they're going to massively inflate their currency. Let's track this and see what happens. But hey, Bernie Sanders is all over this. He thinks that they should absolutely reject all the austerity measures. He wrote last week in the Huffington Post, "I applaud the people of Greece for saying no to more austerity for the poor, the children, the sick, and the elderly," Sanders said in a statement Sunday.
Right. Now print some money out and spend.
In a world of massive wealth and income.
Yeah, I don't think rejecting austerity means what he thinks he means, does it? It's like, if you reject austerity, you're automatically going to be richer or something. I don't know where he comes up with this.
Well, he goes on to say, in a world of massive wealth and income, the inequality, Europe must support Greece's efforts to build an economy which creates more jobs and income, not more unemployment and suffering. So
they don't have to. They definitely do not have to support Greece's their inability to manage money. And I suspect that they won't. Stephen, anything else you want to share tonight?
No, I just want to say that I'm enjoying you guys. I just found you recently on the radio, and keep up the good work.
Yeah, thanks. Welcome aboard. Glad to have you tuned in out there, and thanks for the call tonight. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. But, you know, Bernie Sanders is a socialist, and so nobody should be surprised that he's saying things like that. And you got to give him credit, though. At least he is saying what he really believes.
Yeah,
you know?
He is consistent.
He actually really is a socialist and will come right out and admit that. And, of course, that means that he's somebody who supports the force of the state, taking from those who have and giving to those who are politically popular.
Absolutely.
We'll continue here in moments. 855-450-FREE. And, look, I don't have a problem helping the sick, the elderly, the infirm, you know, the kids or whoever needs help, the poor. I just want people to do it voluntarily. I want them to do it because they've been persuaded, because they think it's a good idea. Not because the government is forcing them to. But let's talk more about what's going on in Greece, or you can bring up anything you want here on Free Talk Live.
Virtually anyone can hack your cell phone and track your calls, your texts, your emails, your every movement, but only if they can detect a signal. Stay one step ahead of hackers and Big Brother with a Blockit Pocket, a custom-made pocket infused with pure silver that creates a complete Faraday enclosure for your cell phone. For free shipping to the Lower 48, visit blockitpocket.com or call 888-315-9618, blockitpocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
You are an individual with your own thoughts, decisions, and actions. So why should you be penalized for not enrolling in the subpar health insurance mandated by the government when you can be truly independent with Liberty HealthShare, a bold, innovative alternative allowing you to take back control and make your own decisions about your health care? Mention this ad when you call to learn more. 800-714-6993. That's 800-714-6993. Liberty HealthShare. Together, we are one.
Hi, I'm Daryl W. Perry, and I need your help to give away my newest book. Yes, you heard that right. I want to give away my newest book, A Rebel's Journey. The book describes my path to the ideas of liberty, which began as a search for traditional values. I will only give away the book if I reach my fundraising goal of $2,500.
But wait, there's more!
If you donate, not only can you get the ebook and the audiobook for free, but you can get bonus audio content, including interviews with Jeffrey Tucker, Lynn Ulbricht, Ben Stone, Gardner Goldsmith, and Stephen Kinsella. Or you can get a signed copy of the paperback book and more. Your donation will serve to replace the profits I would have earned through a more traditional publication of the book. The funds raised will allow me to get the book into the hands of more people and to promote the book to a wider audience. To find out more about the book or to donate, visit arebelsjourney.com.
If worse comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live, and you can join us here if you want at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. More cash controls coming, or they're going to stay. They're not going anywhere for the people in Greece. And as we talked about before, that means you don't get to pull very much money out of an ATM because, well, they don't have it. That's why they put the restrictions on that. 60 euros is the max that you can withdraw at any one day at an ATM location. There's also the restriction that prevents businesses from sending money over to other countries, which is probably a major reason why we read earlier that businesses are closing their doors. Because how are you going to do business if you have to, you can't pay whoever's providing you with the products that you're selling? So we'll continue with that discussion here. Also, want to invite you to our website where we've got archives. If you've missed a moment of Free Talk Live, you can just go click and download and get as many episodes as you want, going back until as far back as 2006. Even further, actually, we've even got the first and second seasons of Free Talk Live up there, too. So really, you can download as much, more than you could possibly listen to, all for free over at freetalklive.com. So please go and enjoy that. It's Ian and Chris in the studio here tonight. Capital controls, according to the Sunday Times in the UK, are going to be staying in place for at least 6 months. They're looking at, there's a meeting apparently tomorrow where the four main banks and finance ministry officials will discuss how to save the banking system from collapse after a run on deposits. Options include a bad bank to house toxic loans. They may consolidate the four main banks down into two, and a possible forced bail-in of depositors. That means taking your money from your bank account. If you've got a bank account in Greece and it's got 8,000 euro in it or more, they might be taking 30% right off the top. And there will be nothing you can say or do about it because the bank's closed. You can't just go in and get yourself a check written to move that, you know, those euros somewhere else. It's too late for that. Tomorrow's meeting is expected to approve new capital controls, which not only put a cap on withdrawals. Greeks have been unable to withdraw more than 60 euros a day for the past fortnight, but also strict limits on international transfers by the public and businesses. And our toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE if you want to join us. So I guess we're going to know more about what happens tomorrow with these possible cash controls. Maybe it'll get even more restrictive, as though it couldn't get worse.
I just like that it can't happen here. We're America, damn it.
Well, it's not going to happen the same way here, right? Because in America, they can print money out. And in Greece, they can't do that.
Well, they have to rely on somebody else to print their money. When you're talking about the euro, or if it's the drachma, they can inflate their own currency again, too.
Well, right. And that's if they leave the euro, then they can start up the printing presses.
And they will.
Damn well better believe they will, which, of course, will mean that they will likely get into a period of inflation and possible hyperinflation very quickly thereafter.
So we're running about 104, 105% of GDP as our national debt, I think, right now. Somewhere around there. I know we're over 100%, but not by far.
What do you mean by that?
It means the total money borrowed and owed exceeds the total value of all production in the United States. Everything bought and sold in the United States, if you add up that big number, if it's $X trillion per year, we owe that much money.
I don't know anything. I don't know what you're talking about.
That's all right.
It's not my deal. I didn't agree to any of this.
What social contract?
But I thought the debt was way higher than the GDP here.
Well, depending on how you calculate. If you calculate in on costs of Medicaid and Medicare that go far into the future, yeah, you can make it as high as you want.
Mm.
But by most measures, it's over 100% of GDP. So Greece right now is at 170%. So if you think about it, it doesn't seem like we're that far off from experiencing the same sorts of issues that they're going to. It's what I will say for us is we have a Fed that will manipulate everything.
Right. The Fed will be the bailout in this case, right? The Federal Reserve is essentially the lender of last resort for the U.S. federal government. And so when nobody, was it bonds, I guess they put out there, when nobody wants to buy the bonds,
they'll buy them.
Then the Federal Reserve, it's their job to print money out and buy those bonds. And so they have a way of sort of extending the financial calamity here as long as they possibly can. They got quite a few tricks up their sleeve. And they're not beholden to anyone else. I mean, yeah, there's a lot of creditors, like China and whatever, I'm sure, but who's going to want to bail the U.S. out when the time comes?
That used to be the joke. I mean, it used to be that, well, you know, China pretty much owns us anymore. Well, China doesn't own us anymore. The Federal Reserve owns us. If you want to talk about total debt held, it's more held by the Federal Reserve and people in the United States than it is by any foreign country. But every time they go through another round of money printing, then that is Wall Street owning that much more of the United States.
And by the United States, you mean the U.S. federal government.
Yes.
Because they're not putting up, I mean, they're not putting up the deed to your house as collateral.
Right. But by extension, the federal government lays claim to whatever it wants to, so.
That's true. And the collateral is your labor, right? So when they're saying, well, we'll pay this loan back, they mean that you will be taxed to pay the loan back in the long run. But as you pointed out, Chris, the debt is higher than the GDP, so you can't possibly pay that back. All right. That's not possible.
Now we have to give it 110%.
Yeah, it's all going to come down at some point. You know, the question is when and how ugly of a situation will it be? Because it's not pretty in Greece. It's
not
looking good there. People closing their businesses. I mean, you think the job situation in the U.S. is bad right now. Wait until you get into a situation where businesses can't even do business anymore. That's going to end a lot of jobs real fast.
And a lot of people don't really realize that we are Greece light. You know, we are Venezuela light. We have these massive social programs that we subsidize. Mm-hmm. We subsidize our medical care. We subsidize housing. We take care of the poor and all these things. It's just a matter of scale. And depending on where we go, what decisions we make as a country, that depends on how soon it hits.
Well, you and I aren't making those decisions. That would be the government guys, and we won't have any influence over that. They're going to do whatever they want to do, and it won't matter whether you elect a Republican or Democrat in 2016. It's going to get worse. The spending is going to continue to go up. They're not going to stop it. And for the same, you know, the same reason, the Tsipras guy over in Greece, he's not going to get up there and say he wants to take away the equivalent of Social Security or pensions over in Greece. He's not going to get up and say he wants to remove any of that stuff. That's not politically feasible. It's not politically possible.
No.
Plausible or popular.
Right. I'll vote for the guy who gives me the most. And that's the position he's in. Talking out of both sides of his mouth now because he has to if he wants his country to survive. But we're hearing it, you know, left and right. We've got Bernie and we've got Hillary and we've got all the Republicans, all
They all want to give. Yeah. But of course, first they have to take.
Yep.
In order to do that.
Yep.
And the way they've got these things, these financial systems set up is just, it's set up for failure eventually. Every government fiat currency fails at some point. And, you know, will it be as bad as Zimbabwe when the end comes here? I hope not.
No.
We've actually got some of the Zimbabwe trillion-dollar notes posted in the studio here. Have you ever seen one of those?
Nice.
Chris?
That's my first. I've seen them online.
This is the real deal. Apparently, they just recently made it so you could turn in these old notes in Zimbabwe and get like $5.
Nice.
So you could turn in a trillion-dollar note.
So that's an investment.
Or as 10 trillion. I forget. I think we have a 10 trillion up there. I can't quite read it from here. I think it does say 10 trillion.
Yeah, one is a 10 trillion.
That's... Right. So you could turn in one of those $10 trillion notes and get like $5 out
have
of it.
Have tried paying a Keen parking ticket with it yet?
That would be a hilarious video.
I do.
That's not a bad idea at all. So you can share your thoughts here. Are we right that this is coming to the United States? Or are we just, you know, do you think that that's ridiculous, that it can't happen here? Do you believe that it can't happen, these kind of capital controls and the drastic, dire financial circumstances? Do you believe that you're somehow insulated from it here?
And my question is it by design?
The failure?
Yeah, absolutely.
I would say it is.
Absolutely. When you look at central banking and Rothschild's famous quote, as long as I control the money of a country, I don't care who is elected.
We'll come back with more here in moments at 855-450-FREE. These fiat currencies are a great way to transfer wealth from the average folks to the politically connected, and then just scrap it all when it's all said and done and start over. Bring in the strong bolivar, as they call it in Venezuela, when they rebranded their money. More coming up. It's Free Talk Live.
If worse comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or state in back taxes, you know they'll never stop coming after you. With bank levies, wage garnishments, they'll even seize your home or business. The good news? A government program for tax debt forgiveness. It's called the Fresh Start Initiative.
I'm Paul Sibley with U.S. Tax Shield. We can help navigate the new laws, get you protected, and resolve your tax issues permanently.
Call the experts at U.S. Tax Shield now for your free consultation and get a guaranteed quote to resolve your case. Call 800-436-6451. That's 800-436-6451.
We the people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Our digital freedom is under attack. Look no further than Ross Ulbricht's life sentence to see that. After all, it's not Ross's freedom they're after. It's yours.
It is bigger than Ross and bigger than a website. I think one website is by far less dangerous than the government trampling on our rule of law.
The appeal is underway, and we've organized a grassroots fundraiser at thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. Up for grabs is Cody Wilson's Ghost Gunner, A Week in Costa Rica, My Magic Mud, Ghost Outside the Machine t-shirt.
These prizes are really great. There's a ton more, so go to thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. Please tell all your friends, share it up.
Our grassroots tactics allow for 100% of all funds raised to go directly to freeross.org. So check out thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. And don't forget FreeRoss.org.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used, and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You may join us here in the remaining moments, which are happening right now on this live Sunday edition of the program. With you in studio tonight, you have me, Ian.
And Chris.
And you, if you want to join us here, toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online over at freetalklive.com. And if you like the show and you want to help support Free Talk Live, you can go shop with us at shop.freetalklive.com. You can enter Amazon and Walmart, and whenever you do that, Free Talk Live gets a cut of your purchase. So go to shop.freetalklive.com. Got some interesting news coming out of all kinds of media. There's a detailed piece over at CNN about the man who has escaped from prison twice.
Way to go, buddy.
Now, that has got to be an elite group of people. You're in an elite group of people if you've escaped from prison one time, but to have done it twice in one lifetime, how many people could be in that category?
I love it.
How many? I can't imagine it's more than a handful.
Yeah,
worldwide over the last 100 years.
Right.
Now, maybe prisons were easier to escape from more than 50 or 100 years ago, yeah, or something like that. So you could maybe, if you went back far enough, find somebody in the Wild West or something like that who was able to get some keys from the sheriff and get out of the jail cell or
swing
something.
His belt and hook keys on the hook. Yeah,
but in the realm of modern prison experiences, these things are built fairly strong. It's fairly hard to get out of these places. There, of course, was the two guys in New York who recently escaped, and I think they captured one of them. I heard. I don't know if they captured both. I think they found one of them. Anyway, this Mexican drug lord Joaquin El Chapo Guzman has escaped again. This according to CNN, after Mexico's most notorious drug lords. This isn't just your average bad guy in Mexico. He is one of the top drug kingpins in the world. Most notorious drug lord stepped into a shower and slipped into a tunnel to escape from a maximum security prison. Authorities vowed it wouldn't be long before the Sinaloa cartel chief was behind bars again. Guards last saw Joaquin El Chapo Guzman Saturday night when he escaped through a hole in the shower area of his cell block at the Altiplano Federal Prison that, get this, led to a lighted and ventilated tunnel nearly a mile long.
That is the free market at work right there.
That is amazing. That, you want to talk about resources.
Yeah.
These drug gangs have so much money at their disposal. Can you imagine the cost of building a mile-long underground tunnel, lighted and ventilated, and doing it all without anybody having any idea that it was going on? Right under the noses, literally, of these prison guards.
Right under a maximum security prison. That's insane.
The level of the ballsiness is, it needs to be praised. God has blessed these people. It's amazing. Look, I'm not saying this guy's a nice guy, right? You know, you don't get to be a drug kingpin, you don't get to be El Chapo by being a nice guy. I mean, these are dangerous people. there have been horrible decapitations. I don't mean that this should be taken lightly, that this guy is necessarily out. But I got to give credit where credit's due. Whenever you can do a breakout from a prison, you deserve some serious credit. I mean, that's awesome. And then to do it in this kind of a manner, a lighted and ventilated tunnel. In fact, I read somewhere, I don't know if they have it in this story, that there was like a motorcycle waiting for him in there too. So, you know, he slipped out, hops on a bike, and then just tears out of there.
Oh, I love it. It gets better and better. Yep.
Mexican President Enrique Peña Nieto said a massive manhunt was underway to find Guzman. Speaking to reporters Sunday from France, where he's traveling on a state visit, Peña Nieto avoided mentioning the drug lord by name, but he said he was closely following news of the escape of a man who has been among the most wanted criminals in Mexico and around the world. He said he was deeply troubled by a very unfortunate event that has outraged a Mexican society. He vowed that his government would recapture Guzman, step up prison security, and investigate whether any prison workers helped break the kingpin out. This represents, without a doubt, an affront to the Mexican state, but I'm also confident that the institutions of the Mexican state, particularly those in charge of public safety, are at the level with the strength and determination to recapture this criminal. Guzman is the storied boss of one of the world's most powerful and deadly drug trafficking operations. He escaped originally in 2001 from a high-security prison in a laundry cart and was not apprehended again until 2014 when he was arrested at a Mexican beach resort.
See, now this is capitalism at work. Before, he could only afford a laundry cart to escape in, and now he's got a mile-long ventilated tunnel. Lights. And a motorcycle waiting for him.
It's
epic. That is great.
Now, why stay in Mexico? Why, from 2001 to 2014, why were you still there, Mr. Guzman? What was the point of staying there? I mean, I guess he's overseeing his operations and everything, but...
He could. I mean, with the amount of money that those guys have amassed, the amount of power they control, I mean, we have companies in the United States that exert that kind of control on our government. Why do you think that he would not be safe down there?
Well, that's a good point, right? I mean, if you are the cops and you go and you happen to come across this guy, right? You're looking wherever it is you are as a cop, you happen to come across El Chapo at this Mexican beach resort. Do you really want to be the guy who makes the arrest? I mean, yeah, you're probably going to get praise from your bosses, but you might also get killed.
Or he may be losing the extra $1,000 a month or whatever he gets as a bribe, you know, from that gang to just turn the other.
You'd be better off looking the other way. Even if he wasn't getting the $1,000 a month, I'm sure El Chapo would offer it to him right then.
Here,
why don't you go somewhere else? and it would seem to be an easy choice. Let's go to Jeff. He's in Elgin, Illinois. You can bring up anything. Jeff, you're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Jeff and LJ.
Hello, can you hear me good?
Yes, sir. Go
can
ahead,
hear me?
Sir. Yes.
Yep. Okay. I was going to say, it sounds like you could make a movie out of this guy. They got Hogan's Heroes. They're always digging tunnels there, you know. And then the other thing is, you were talking about the Federal Reserve and the central banksters. They're actually the communists in the Communist Manifesto. Everything else is window dressing. The central bank is the fifth plank. Because they want to have a future foreclosure, national foreclosure, which is the same thing as the communist revolution. And we can kind of make our own money in a way. If you can do something and barter it, that's sort of like making your own money.
Sure. A lot of planks of the Communist Manifesto have been implemented, and they have been implemented for a long time. And certainly central banking, I think, is one of them, right?
They're the national tapeworm. I make things out of wood for people, like engravings and stuff. And so sometimes it's possible to use things that you make in trade for things, you know. So we should do that as much as possible.
Thanks, Jeff, for your call tonight. Appreciate it. Toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. Yeah, it would be great to get away from the central banking cartels, but unfortunately that's not going to happen anytime soon at the national level. But you personally can get away from it by using alternative currencies, whether it's Bitcoin, silver, gold. Of course, you can go and get gold and silver at gold.freetalklive.com. And if you want Bitcoin, you can go to expresscoin.com. I think Bitcoin is really a solution for people, and it's happening in Greece. People are in Greece buying Bitcoin now more than ever. They are all of a sudden very interested in something besides the euro, and that's helping them.
And I think the price spike, while it may not be the people of Greece driving up the price, It makes me wonder how many people around the world are looking at Greece and going, having a safe store of value might not be a bad idea for me. And I'd like to watch the prices of gold and silver and see what they do over this too. But I suspect that there is some of that. People going, I need a safer place for a couple bucks.
The writing is on the wall. The canary is in the mine. That is Greece. So, yeah, people who are paying attention absolutely may be looking at other options. Although, it should be clarified, Bitcoin may not be a safe store of value. It is an investing kind of thing. There's a risk involved, and you shouldn't invest more than you can afford to lose. But all that said, over time, Bitcoin has done pretty well. Yes, there was that spike to 1,000 that if you bought at 1,000, you're probably pretty upset about Bitcoin right now. But if you bought at 200, then you're feeling pretty good right now because it's now over 300 at the moment. So you don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. So the world's most powerful drug lord, Guzman, heads the Sinaloa cartel, which the U.S. Justice Department describes as one of the world's most prolific, violent, and powerful drug cartels. He was considered the world's most powerful drug lord until his arrest in Mexico in February of 2014. And I guess his arrest did not end the Sinaloa cartel because somebody done built that tunnel for him, right? So just goes to show that even if you crack down on the top guy in a drug gang, they're still going to keep operating.
They didn't get the top guy.
You think there's somebody who's above him?
No, Washington. Oh. If it weren't for our war on drugs, that guy could not have made the money that he has.
That's absolutely true. And maybe someday the war on drugs will end. But in the meantime, we'll have to watch and see if he gets caught again and then makes a third escape. Because, wow, two escapes in one lifetime. That's pretty amazing. We'll see you tomorrow night. Online in the meantime at freetalklive.com.
NASA's recent discovery of water on Mercury has led to speculation among scientists that the planet could potentially sustain an intergalactic space prison housing the universe's worst criminals. Scientists believe that organic compounds found on the planet's surface could be useful for creating an off-world space Australia, where strength is the only law. However, they caution it is too early to say whether or not fights among the space jail's prisoners would be broadcast here on Earth for the entertainment of wealthy gamblers. But NASA's lead researchers do say that Mercury's ability to support human life raises important questions about who the prison guards would be.
Perhaps the guards themselves would be space mercenaries, or maybe we'd just use robots.
The robots would have guns for hands.
Well, obviously.
Critics inside NASA caution against funneling too many resources into the Mercury project when it would be so much cooler to build a prison on the moon ruled by clones of the prisoners themselves. Researchers encourage the public to read their findings, which have been released in the form of a graphic novel titled The Mercury Cipher.
This is the Onion News Network.
Why are you playing a slot machine sound for an online poker site?
Do you have a poker sound effect? Because we have a new advertiser, swcpoker.eu.
Brought to you by the same guys that did Seals with Clubs.
Now they're called swcpoker.eu. It's Bitcoin Poker 2.0. They have lots of new games, including Chinese poker. The Krill leaderboard is active now. It's Bitcoin Poker from the brand you trust, swcpoker.eu.
Get on over to swcpoker.eu and start playing now. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Liberty Conspiracy is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, July 12th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.61 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,163 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $309.